it for my wins. I need my hands. This life is real. You play pretend. Game off the bench. I get it in. I get it in. I get it in. It for my wins. I need my hands. This life is real. You play pretend. Game off the bench. I get it in. I get it in. I get it in. I'm on my job. I get it done, but you should know that. Shine like a sun of 101, you should know that. I get the front and in the back, you should know that. No need to stun, it's never cap, you should know that. All I know, 10 toes, never fold. Bay roll, on the go. Ice hole, ice hole, ice hole. Came for my wins, I need my hands. It's like a play for 10, came off the bench. I get it in, I get it in, I get it in. Came for my wins.
Ah, yes, my boys. Back at it again. The time has finally come. The clap the enemy. Jeez! I've got some interesting, spicy combos, my boy. Music, you got Murray by Karen Curry. Oh, no. Revive this man. Now you're a revive a plus five charisma. Congratulations. Come get him. With the summon go. Summon go. Yes, what's good, my boys? Welcome back to the stream. Says, what would you guys like in the next year when pendulums get released? Wait, is it almost time for that? Advanced summon, fusion summon, synchro summon, exceed summon, pendulum shokan. Link shokan, credit card shokan, maximum summon. Yes, actually, didn't even dawn on me, but yeah, it soon will be time for Pendulum World. I have a Frosty, by the way. That's actually a good thought. What do I don't actually I don't actually big real talk. I hate pendulums, similar to why the same reason I hate invoked. And don't get me wrong, I don't hate the pendulum mechanic. I actually like the pendulum mechanic in Triple D. I like the pendulum mechanic in the name just slipped my mind, but those amorphages. But I just didn't like the monkey board combo thing that was going on. I thought that was pretty busted and degenerate, but they fixed that. And then I did not like Pendulum Magicians, because when I tried to play Yu-Gi-Oh again, I used to get beat to death by this same dude every week, and he's playing Pendulum Magicians, and he was such an ass about it. And I was so disgusted because I was just trying to play my Darkest Diabolos. So it's crazy. Pendulum probably aren't going to be bad, but I mean, having the ability to special summon a bunch of monsters all at once is just busted. I actually had a decent idea for a spicy little OTK deck, but using the Machina Monsters and Photon Cerberus, but I didn't get a chance to test it out too much. But I mean, honestly, Xyz got a lot to look forward to. First off, you already know we're going to get all those random Neos forms. So what summon skull deck am I playing, my boy? Oh, I'm playing my What Grows in the Graveyard Call of the Archfiend deck. This deck got me a nice little win streak. I called it Paleo Skull because back when I was playing this, I was using three Paleozoic Canadia and three of the trap card that cuts the attack in half. So basically, I would use the 4400 beater, Archfiend's Call, to swing in, but I had the little paleo cards coming back unaffected by my opponent's cards that I could use. And I just did not, though they never popped off for me. I never got to use the effects. They were always getting destroyed and banished. So I was like, if the back row's gonna get destroyed and banished regardless, I felt like I'm gonna run my best back row. And best back row is Bad Aim to kill Karakiri. It's a super rare that kills a meta deck. I love it. We haven't seen something like this since Super Rush Headlong and Drowning Mirror Force, because Drowning Mirror Force is just ridiculous, because so many people are just attacking into the back rows for granted because they expect it to be Fiendish Chain, but it's a Fiendish Mirror Force and then you lose. So I'm really enjoying my Fiendish Mirror Force. Yeah, like attack. I'm like a Mirror Force. They're like, what? And then also, take a look. My KC Cup is doing real good. See, look at this. Clapped all these fools. This was, what time was it? 6:30 in the morning? Yeah, I was still up with the baby. Well, not with the baby, but I was up seeing after the baby. So look how fast my games were. 5:30, 5:34, 5:40, 5:43, 5:46, 5:52, 5:55, 6:04. 6:13, 6:20. 6:20 to 6:13 might have been my longest game, 7 minutes. All the rest of the games was just bang, 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 bang. But honestly, I'm probably not going to come back to the KC Cup at all. If I do go back to the KC Cup, I'll probably decide to do that like tomorrow or something like that and play. Because when I play it, I got to be in a different mood. I'm not the same kind of dude that plays it when I normally play Yu-Gi-Oh! Like I feign disgust when I play Yu-Gi-Oh! But when I'm playing KC Cup, it's like tournament, so I'm trying to be like serious, and it's not that best. Bro, Aroma Mage is clapping right now. I know it is. Cause you maniacs won't stop playing it. Jesus Christ. Honestly, I don't like a Aroma Mage. Cause they stole everything from me. Oh, see, look at this. He's just giving it up. So I'll take it. Trumpeter dog. Aroma Mages, man. It's a free-to-play deck. Everybody like it. But it's funny, like, man, I can't get with the Aroma Mages. And it's not because they waifu flowers or nothing like that. Honestly, okay, if I'm going to do Protect the Castle style gameplay, this is as much Protect the Castle I'll do. Summon the untargetable monster, set back row, and fight for the monster. That's as much as I'll do. But playing like three continuous traps or two traps and a spell, I just don't like that. I just don't like it at all. I just don't like that gameplay. I mean, it's okay gameplay. Some people like it. Not me. But hey, if we're going to have to fight back row, man, you're going to have to fight my back row, my boy. It's three in the back row. That's what I'm setting. What are you setting? Three in the back row. That's what I'm setting. Hey, you made it. Thanks, my boy. Dev. Thank you for surrendering your life to the Archfiend's Call. Dodo. Ooh, nice. Be gone. Thank you for the offering. That happened a lot too in the KC Cup. People would just see this. They would see the skull and see three cards set and just scoop. Hey, back row meta. See, this is the advantage. Okay, let me explain to you the logic of this deck, because I got to talk about this deck a little more, because this deck deserves some praise. I don't know if y'all remember this, but I played this deck on a stream. I told y'all I was working on my KC Cup decks. I was training. That's why I had to pilot the Karakiri deck, and I decided to record some of that so I could get y'all to know that. But take a look at this deck. Let me just break it down for you. So top deck is Karakuri, and we're running Bad Aim for that. And basically, against that deck, their biggest monster is 2800. But with oil, it can get even higher. But what's funny is all their effects target. And most of them don't play Floodgate. But if they do, you run stuff like Lance. So Floodgate's going to happen. It's normally going to happen before you summon the Archfiend's Call. So then you drop Lance and you on Angel Trumpeter. And then you get out the Trumpeter, you do your Synchro, you do your thing. Archfiend's Call, right? But when you drop the call, he's 2,500 and they're all higher than him, of course, obviously. But they typically don't have back row removal. They have counters. They have traps that they respond to. So they normally try to run over there. And I was using Wall of D instead of Drowning Mirror Force. What made me change Drowning Mirror Force to, I mean, change Wall of D to Drowning Mirror Force is a situation that basically there was an opponent attacking me. They did some kind of convoluted shenanigan and basically made my Wall of D useless. But if it was drowning would have just got him up out of here and it would have been nothing he could do. So that's just Drowning Mirror Force is a catch-all for most decks. Bad Aim is a catch-all for Karakuri, but it also claps most decks. And this card right here, Painful Decision, I literally was not had to make a painful decision on putting three in this deck, because three of this card in the deck is just so treacherous. So this is what I mean. Okay, if this deck all revolves around this card, that means you have to make this card or Brachylion, one or the other, as soon as possible, right? If you're gonna make it as soon as possible, then you gotta run six. You gotta run three Painful and this. So because I was running three, I ran Karma Cut instead of Drowning. I ran Karma Cut instead of Bad Aim. And I realized Bad Aim was a better card than Karma Cut because Bad Aim doesn't cost and Bad Aim will destroy a card, where Karma Cut doesn't banish a card, but that banish comes at a price from my hand, and also timed right, that banish could mean nothing. So Bad Aim is really good because it's a combo breaker. You know, your opponent activates Cosmic Cyclone because they're about to start the combo, but the monster on the field is still there. So Bad Aim, kill that monster. They're like, fuck. You know, it's really funny. It's like when I set Bad Aim, my mental math is like, don't move. And if you move, you get shot. So yeah, Bad Aim. And then Painful Decision, you just run the risk of a brick on this, which is fine. And basically the whole idea is to drop the call, summon another Trumpeter and go in for game, or summon the Glee Phantom Bird. Now people ask me, why use the Phantom Bird over Breaker? I will tell you, my boy. Phantom Bird effect activates off of his normal summon. Breaker's effect activates to add a counter on his normal summon. There's a big difference on that. So if I summon Breaker and you flip Kanadia, Breaker's going down and I'm not gonna get to break shit. Sure, I got the Kanadia still, sure. But Breaker's going down. But if I summon the Phantom Bird, not only am I gonna destroy one card on the field, if you need to play Kanadia, you'll play that too. So Bird will get more value in the end. That's why I like to run the Bird. Also, if it's special summon, it can destroy a card. Not saying I gotta mean to special summon it, but if it ever is, you can Hakai a card. He's kind of like that, like remember how I was using Stratos and the Earth dude and the Earth hero. And then we're running Forbidden Lance because Lance, man, Lance just gets you out of trouble. And I would run back row removal like Cosmic or Trunade, but you don't need that because our main monster is unaffected by targets, which is half of the meta. And then Brachylion, which can also negate any trap. And mainly you only see these two. And I get a lot of Brionic for games on the first turn. But yeah, that's it. I'm not gonna KC it tonight, my boy. I am not gonna KC it tonight. I'm not gonna put it myself through the high pressure and stress. Honestly, I can't KC Cup and YTDan at the same time. I cannot. YTDan is his own mental math. Like doing the YTDan, being the YTDan. You can't do both, man. I can't KC Cup and be like, fool, I activate, because I gotta get into fucking, you know. What's the hold up? What do you have? Oh, I gotta get into the actual gameplay because I want to win. Because honestly, what's funny is when I'm playing on YouTube, I kind of like, it's almost like a Zen mode. It's almost like a form of meditation. Like, this is where I am, this is what I'm doing, and like, I appreciate and I love this space. It's like that, right? But if I go to a tournament, or if I play KC Cup, it's like, this is what I must do. I know that sounds stupid, but that's just how it be, man. This is how it be. And you know what's funny? I also got a nice, I'm going to tell y'all about a couple tech cards in a minute. I got some good tech cards that I've been working with that I think is really good. Level duplication. Where are you going? What? Yikes. Coral Dragon is good. I just don't use Coral Dragon because Bryonic ends the game. Like, because in this deck, since you run Battletuned, it's like you don't want to Sheer Nui effect. Okay. Since you run Battletuned, you don't want to, like Battletuned is a great card, right? And will end the game in one turn. You want to be able to play Battletuned. That's like at any time. Oh. Sorry. Yeah. Now all I gotta do is hit that battle tune for game. See, bad aim is amazing, man. All I gotta do is draw battle tune for game. Dudo. Oh, that worked too. Summon Dark Verger. Oh, DD Ho. You maniac. He DD Ho'd. He DD Ho'd. Oh, and he Floodgate Trap Hold. You maniac. He DD Ho'd and Floodgate Trap Hold my beast. I can't believe you did that. Take this 25, you maniac. Oh, he's got a Kite Roy too. Let me see what else he's got in here. He's got a Kite Roy to some shit too. He's got a Sun Saga pop too. That's not good. I'm doing good, my boy. Said Fisher is good with Black Wings. Fisher is good with any deck that you can get aggressive with, my boy. Fisher is really good. I will almost use Fisher in this deck, but we use Battletune. I would really wish I had a top deck that Battletune, but I did not. Oof! My Mirror Force. Damn. Come forth. Summon Skull. He's like, what? Impossible. Summon Skull here in our world. Damn. Now bad aim is bad on the top deck. Damn. He tilted me with that DD Crow. Damn. A good move on the DD Crow. Nobody's playing that. Nobody. I don't even got the balls to play DD Crow. Shit. This is one of those instances that Wall of D and shit like that would be coming in handy right now. Dudo. All right. Boom, 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 boom. He knows what my face down is. All right. So he's gonna do that. I cannot touch this man with the bad aim, so it might as well hold it. Wait till he does something. Hey, Joshua, thanks for becoming a member, my boy. I appreciate it. Oh, he didn't go get for the 7. He's going for 6. Okay, well, that's fine. We can take that. I'll appreciate that. So we can top deck and win. Because there's one monster in the deck. He's got 1,500 attack points. And he wants the attack for game. Here's my big saga dog. And they're going to read you a story. It's called GG. No. My beast. I reveal the mighty mirror force. Return your monsters to your filthy deck. Impossible. How about a little bad aim, dog? Tell me what this is. I take my L. Oh, it's floodgate. Shit. I wouldn't have been able to get him anyway. It's floodgate. Damn. Honestly, floodgate and DD Crow fucked me up. That's actually a good combo. Floodgate and DD Crow. That was actually a good combo. Floodgate and my monster. DD Crow my target. Let me see how many DD Crows he runs. Just one? Oh, he runs two. Okay. Well, I mean, that's a part of his focus strategy of keeping his opponent at bay. And he definitely did that. But he came that close to losing. GG. Can't hate on that one. Can't hate on that one. He had the Forbidden Lance. Lance is good, bro. Don't sleep on Lance. You got it. Well, the deck doesn't brick, per se. What happens is, you can get countered. And I got countered. See, it's like you always have a monster. Like you always have the monster, see? But the problem is, you know, if someone directly counters what you're doing, like no one, like this right here, this is Brionic for game. So let's try Brionic for game. Cause we might be able to do Brionic for game. Cause when I summon, he's gonna try something, but that might be Cosmic Cyclone, real talk. Cause I just played this, unless that's a counter. Is that a counter or Cosmic Cyclone? We'll see what it is. It's a counter. And it's not just a counter, it's the counter. Okay, this is what I'm talking about. So this is the difference between KC Cup and real life. You got maniacs. And I don't know what he's playing. Curse Seal of the Forbidden Spell, discarding Wonder Wand? The fuck is this? But it's fine because we've run 3 of these, but now they're banished forever. But what is this? It says you can reveal this card and target. What the fuck? You're my wonder wall. Draw that, scamp. Draw that, you scamp. Ah, skiddy-ding. You bastard. You son of a bitch. Take that, you scamp. Take 15, you scamp. You got a Karibo or something? Like, take 15, you scamp. You scamp. This man. Curse Seal of the Forbidden Spell. You'll never play that card around me ever again. What? That's right. I've stopped your entire deck. Killed. You may have stopped my entire deck killed, but you still have to deal with my broken bird. Attack. Bird man. Bird strike. Bird. Are you gonna die to the bird man? Are you literally gonna just die to the bird man? If I stopped your whatever the fuck this was? Are you gonna die to the bird man? Sweet Jesus! He's gonna die to the bird man. Good Lord. I don't know. He's gonna die to the bird man. It's ridiculous. Curse Seal is a forbidden spell. Aha! You beat me up with the Birdman. Oh, Karibo. That's a good choice to use for the Birdman. Because he's got 15 attack and 15 defense. He's the perfect warrior. I don't know what he's playing. I don't know what this is, bro. Said, I want to really play a lot of decks. It says, but empty pockets. I feel you, boy. I feel you, my boy. I feel you. Come on, Scamp. What are you doing? Double Cyclone. All right. Bye. You scamp! What the fuck is this? Who hurt this man? Who hurt this man? That's all I want to fucking know. Who hurt him? He really doesn't like fucking back row, bro. He really don't like spell cards, bro. Who hurt you? Who hurt you, dog? Who did it? Damn. Who did it? You gotta look at his deck, bro. You gotta look at his deck. God damn. Wow, it's Invoke. What kind of scam is this? Drossin's Water, Invoke, Double Cyclone, Curse Seal, Forbidden Spell. What is this shit, bro? What? Wow. Wow. He like, I'm dead. I'm dead. Jeep. All right, Jeep. What? 35 cards? How? Oh, Grandpa's cards. How did they find a way to do that? How the fuck they find a way to do 35 cards, bro? How did they fucking do that? I was about to lose it. I was like, what? I'm like, they found the maniac. Not a maniac. The maniac. He's like, hello, my name is Maniac. First name, V. Tri-Mids are actually so disgusting in this meta right now. And Tri-Mids versus this deck, man. Man, it's like a Dragon Ball Z battle, man. It's crazy. It's a lot of, like, if I get a good match in against the Tri-Mid deck, it'll be very interesting. But the thing about Tri-Mids, about the matchup I don't like, is that Drowning Mirror Force doesn't work against them. So it will, in most cases. Against them, I would prefer that this was like I don't know, anything else. What? This man activated Charge of the Light Brigade and sent Exodia's head and right arm to the graveyard. Impossible. Exodia can't obliterate my summoned skull. But I didn't expect for his deck to be offensive. I thought he was going to be running a, oh, you son of a bitch. I didn't expect this. I expected it to be something else, but impossible. He's discarded another piece of the forbidden. What is he planning? A cunning strategy, no less. Duddle. Yeah, these rando decks, like all the other decks in KC Cup were very aggressive. I have no idea what the fuck I'm dealing with in these other shits. Wow, he put three pieces of Exode in the grave and two Lightsworn cards. And if I attack right now, my monster would be weakened by something in hand. Target one spoken monster in the graveyard. Except chucking special. What? Attack! Well, no. Yeah. Attack! With Summon Skull! Or, yes, his name is Summon Skull, actually. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. I just need him to start playing some stuff. Like sitting on this little, sitting on his laurels on this shit will actually cost me the game. And I mean, he definitely could sit on his laurels. I mean, he really could. It would be annoying, but he could. Okay, good. He's not sitting on his laurels. Bad aim dog. Ooh. Bad aim dog. Oof. Oof. Wow. Wow. This guy, bro. Creature seizure. Fucking magicalized fusion. This shit is crazy. What the fuck? Quentin! 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 Why Quentin? What is this? What the fuck is this? Quentin, Lightsworn, Exodia, Karibo, Magicalized. See, this is why I wanted to play Legend right here. You never know what you gonna fucking get. What the fuck, bro? What the fuck, bro? Didn't you just see the Drowning Mirror Force, you maniac? All that shit back. All right, Deck, come on. It's time for you to come through. We need to get to our beast. What? What? So much. No. Oh, my God. All right. Passing turn. What the fuck, bro? Dice it. What the fuck is that going to do? Bacon Saver. What the fuck? What is he trying to do? It's Birdman, bitch. He back. And he want a little bit of back row. What? What? What the fuck? What was that? What was that, bro? What was that? He is legend. He is legend. Guys, he was deck, bro. Thank you, Mr. Jeep. Oh my God. What the fuck? Well, at least he didn't net deck it, dog. At least he didn't net deck it. And he runs three of these. He loves this card. He loves head judging. Isn't even using a skill to use head judging. He fucking loves head judging. He probably gets so many dubs off of this. Summon Skull saved my ass. If I didn't have Summon Skull, I would be dead right here. Summon Skull, protect my body. Yeah, I actually won because of Summon Skull. And I will tell you, as I built this deck so many times, I literally was like, you know what? I can't play Summon Skull. Like I can't play Summon Skull. I would take it out. But then I would go, no, I got to put it back in. I'll go and put it right back in. Wazee, thanks for that $5, my boy. He said, what up, my boy? He said, hope your night is going well. He said, any archetypes you're waiting for Duel Links? Am I waiting for anything? Honestly, all the old school shit that I used to really like, I think is mostly already come out. So am I waiting for anything? I kind of don't think so. But I'm really, really enjoying stuff though in Duel Links. All right, now this can be annoying because he wants to be able to go right into the Sun Boy, and Sun Boy can cause a lot of problems. But he's got two in the graveyard, and he didn't play anything else, so this could be interesting to say the least. He's got the two in the graveyard. Why am I thinking about that? We can just Bryonic him for game. Let's just Bryonic him for game. I was over here thinking about my strategies and shit, acting like I was just some regular duelist. I forgot that I never meet. See, this is what I'm talking about, KC Cup stuff. I'll be sitting up there like, all right, it's time to give him Bryonic and move to the next duel. And I wouldn't even say anything. I would just summon Bryonic game and then just go on. I would take no joy in this action. I would just do it, execute the combo. But now I'm like, you have now faced the full power of Bryonic. And you aren't even ready for this. Bryonic! Bryonic dog! And I'll use Bryonic's special effect. By discarding a card from my hand, I can send a monster back to your deck. And I'm not done. I'm placing two cards face down. And I'm doing battle. If this damage goes through, you're finished. Bryonic! Fool. You've fallen for the classic blunder.
Battle tune, dog.
That's how we get rid of Shiranui, boy. That's how we get rid of Shiranui. Bryonic! Bye-bye. I love shitting on them like that. I love it.
Bryonic, bye bye. All right, say goodbye, nice guy. Bryonic. Jidex. Bryonic, bye bye.
Let's do it. Yeah, I really like to get into the duels, man, but I cannot get, it's like, I can't get into it like that if I'm playing KC Cup. Cause all while I was playing KC Cup, I'm gonna tell y'all how I played KC Cup last night. I'm gonna tell y'all I played it, and this is how, maybe he just didn't have any back row. Sometimes they just don't have back row. But this is what happens, okay? I'm like with the baby and wife and everything, I literally didn't have any free moments until the wee hours of the night and the wee hours of the morning. That's why my KC Cup times are so weird. This is each player's turn. This card activate target by a card or effect that targets this card for an attack. Again, change my options and show some of my shit. So I can't even do the damn thing. Yeah, we can just go with the bait. But yeah, I could only really play like, it was basically like 3-ish a.m. to like 5 or 6-ish a.m. What? Bad aim? No, that's my tactic. You left me in the lurch. You son of a bitch. You sack of wine. And when I played the games, I just kind of sat there, chilled out, was kicking it, you know, doing my thing. But I could get into it to like really do what I had to do. But unfortunately, it was just, you know, it was only just a little bit of time I could play. Because after that, you know, everybody's pulling your attention. Like when the baby got up, I almost took a time limit loss trying to, you know, win the game against somebody. Killing that Alistair would not help me at all. But I know that he's at least like, I mean, I wonder what he's going to summon. Like, good Lord. That's not going to be good. Whatever it is. All right. Get that chick off the board. Invocation. Let's go. Like, cause if he makes a big fat cockatiss, then that'll work out great. But if he makes a fucking anything else, I'll be a little worried. I'll be a little worried. What? Wonderwaj? Aw, bro. Wonderwaj, you fuckhead. God damn. Fuckhead, Wonder One. Ah, fuck you. That's just game. It's like nothing I could do. There's nothing I could do. Also, I didn't open with it. Actually, let me look at this shit. I didn't open with a chalice. I played three, so whatever. I just didn't get it. But yeah, that's just a game. Because at that point, it's Wonder One. Let him go through with it or not. It's still in the grave. He already has invocation. He's got a water monster. I got earth monsters all over the place. So it's like, yeah, that's just game. It's too far gone at this point. This asshole's playing fucking Wonder Wand. Like, all right. Maybe if he didn't play Wonder Wand, but he played fucking Wonder Wand. It's like, all right, well, I guess that's it then. I guess you got me, bro. It's a Wonder Wand. Hey, it's Wonder Wand, man. What are you gonna do? But yeah, like I was saying, I only had a couple wee hours to play. And when I had those wee hours playing, honestly, I didn't get hype. I literally remember not getting hype until I killed the Karakiri deck with this deck for the first time. I didn't get hype until that happened. Until that happened, I was just playing Yu-Gi-Oh. Just trying hard to win. Like, I kind of, like, honestly, I would have been so disgusted if I played against a dude like that in the Casey Cup. Because it's like, dude, you aren't even taking this seriously. like honestly, when I play in the Casey Cup and I feel like people aren't taking it seriously, it makes me mad because, you know, I'm like, I'm taking this shit seriously, bro. Why aren't you? What the fuck's happening here? Like, you know what I'm saying? Bye-bye. Oof. So I don't know. It's like, so that's why when I like play tournaments and shit, you know, I be like, I'm fucking serious as shit, bro. I be so serious. Just like, I don't know. It's just weird. It's hard to explain. I'm just like, I don't know. I'm like Arnold Schwarzenegger. Like, this is my task. Like from the fucking Terminator. I'm like, this is my task. This is what I'm doing. And my brain can't think of anything else. And it's like, the only thing that snapped me out of it literally was the cry of the baby as he woke up a little too early. And when he woke up, it kind of took me out of this dual trance. That's what I'm going to call it. I'm going to call it a dual trance. And I was just kind of in my phone, just like, just doing the shit that I heard. Why? Why? Oh, why? Why? And then I was like, oh shit. And then I go to change diaper. But as I'm changing the diaper, the clock is running up. And I'm thinking, oh shit, I can't get a time limit loss in the KC Cup while I'm changing a fucking diaper. That's the lamest excuse in the universe. So I literally changed the diaper with one hand and clapped cheeks with the other. It was just, you know, ridiculous. So yeah, I just be like, no, I don't be angry. I don't be angry. I'm not mad. I be serious. I don't know how to explain that. Like, I don't know how you, like, you know how you watch an anime and they be like, oh man, this guy, they getting real serious now. Yeah, I be serious, not mad. I'm serious. Like I used to be the guy that go to the tournament, and if I went to the tournament, like, okay, going to the tournament, let's have fun, it's Friday, da da da. But then if regionals was coming out and I was like, it's time to duel. I don't know. I really don't know how to explain that. This deck, you might have. What? Now, it's funny enough, this brick hand right here is the only kind of brick hand that they can stop you with in this deck. Because if you get any other assortment of cards, it's a wrap. But if you get 2/2 of any card, it's fucking terrible. It's terrible. Oh no. Oh my God. Oh my God. Bro. You said you need more Mickey Mouse. Mickey Mouse. What? And it was funny. I only get like that with something competitive that I really care about. Cause I used to get like that for Smash Bros. Brawl back in the day. And that was the only, what? Ties that tilt, that's it? And you attacking? What? What? Ah. Bruh. All right. Dodo. All right, well, we're gonna win this game right now. Yeah, if I summon and then he activates dual wield, then I could just pop this off and be safe, right? Yeah, summon, dual wield. No, he could pick my two mon. Oh no. Yeah, if he's got dual wield, he's gonna dual wield me regardless. Okay. Yeah, cause I'm gonna have two monsters. Okay. Or maybe he won't dual wield me cause I got the face down. And he's gonna think, well, I can dual wield him anytime I want. Maybe he'll do that. And then I'll say, fool, you've fallen for the classic blunder. If that happens. Dual wield, dog. The forbidden chalice. With my forbidden chalice, my monster will remain on the field, and with the high level of attack points, it'll be strong enough to take down your legendary six samurai secret. It's battle time. I'm attacking, dog. Smacky. Ooh. Let me put this beautiful beast in 3D mode, though. And in my turn, this card is tiny. That's just kind of funny because I was thinking like, I don't know what his other face down is, but I'm sure it's something other scammer-eye bullshit. Dual wield. Bruh. 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 Oh. Bruh. Say what? Huh? Ah, why? God. So booty, dog. So booty. So booty. So booty. So booty. He's like, can I get an extra booty with cheese? Double booty sauce? Can I get double booty? All right, set, summon. Oh, look at this guy. He's like, I'm doing it, mama. I'm doing it. I'm performing my synchro summon. Is she in, dog? Is she in? Ain't attacking nothing. I feel you, bro. I feel you. I don't have enough life points to survive, if that's what I think it is. And he can negate me once, for sure. So I can take a big chance. That's the funny thing. What happened? Actually, no, I can't even do that. I can't even test the waters. What would Jesus do? fuck. I'm gonna summon a trumpeter. I'm gonna flip. Do we do we? You got it, man. You got it, good sir. You got it. All right now. All right, got a pass turn. It's all down to this. Will he top deck a monster? Dud up. He's like, I didn't draw a monster, but I drew my third duel wheel. All right, we'll see. Da-da. I summon. Monster effect. Hook height. He's like, Birdman, motherfucker. Fiendish chain he plays. Okie dokie. Okie dokie. Alright. I'm going to set a card face down in my turn. Won't he be surprised? You fool! You've fallen for the classic blunder! Boosting my boy!
Are you ready for his assault?
No! That's impossible! That's why I brought another! You've fallen for the classic blunder! Now!
Strike back through the shadowy chains! Birdman, motherfucker! Birdman, bitch. Birdman.
Oh, this ain't the one where I got old boy in it. You got lucky. You got lucky. You son of a mother. You got lucky. It's kind of whack. It's like, I can't attack. It's this weird situation. I can't attack. His monster's face down is probably something like this. I can't really afford to lose any damage. So all I can do is really set two cards and pass. That's all I can really do. Cause Birdman can't attack.
Birdman, motherfucker.
That's right. Look on his face. He's not gonna put up with your shit or mine. It's like a fucking Birdman.
The fuck you want from me?
I'm like, okay, Birdman.
She. I'm motherfucking Birdman.
Like, all right. You hear what I said? Like, okay, I heard the Birdman. I heard your shit. Don't beat me, Birdman. Now we can go Bryonic. We can go Borky Lion. We can go Skull. And I kind of want to go Bryonic. But if he's got another Fiendish Chain set, then that would suck. So I think I'm going to go Skull because we can also go into regular Summon Skull too. I think I'm going to go Skull. I think that's an easy play. And we are... Oh no, dog! I can't use dual wheel no more. Poor bastard. I can't use dual wheel. I took Cowboy out. I forgot I took Cowboy out. I had Cowboy in a different deck. I did have Cowboy in here originally, but I took Cowboy out and just forgot to put him back in. And I only had this in here to protect this from Sun Saga sometimes. and that situation only came up one time and I really didn't even get a chance to do it. So, but I still want to keep my eight in there though. I think I only really need one Bryonic. I totally forgot. I was like, oh yeah, don't I got a Gaga Cowboy. But even if I had exceeded for Cowboy, he would have been like, go Fiendish Chain. And I would have been like, and he would have been like, you'll never cowboy me for game. That's why I'll summon a samurai. I'm like, oh no. He's like, oh yeah. Then it wouldn't have been fun, my boy. It wouldn't have been fun because I would have died. Nah, he would have had Fiendish Chain for sure. He would have had Fiendish Chain. That's why he scooped this immediately when he saw the monster said, I cannot be targeted. He said, you know what? I'm done. He said, what are some good subs for bad aim? Anything that can disrupt the play at all. Anything. You know, bad aim I only use because it destroys a card. But if you can disrupt the play by any means, you know, it's a good replacement for bad aim. Anything that can disrupt the play, like something like a Kanadia, enemy controller, you know, anything. Well, enemy control is not going to really help you against Karakiri, though. You'll probably just... It's basically... You're playing enemy control against them. You're basically playing draw a card. Da-do. Ooh, nice. So you know that face down is Ballista Squad, right? So... Summon. Huh? Dark Verger. My Dark Verger. Fiendish Chain. Good job. My first mind said that he fucked up and he was dumb as hell. But my second mind said, what if he's playing a clever trick? I don't know. I don't know. Is it potato duelist? Yeah, you said he's a potato. Damn it, dog. He said this man was a potato. You said this man was a potato. I would quit too. Oh, he ain't quitting. He ain't going nowhere. He like, I'm right here, bro. I'm right fucking here. All right, okay, shit. You gotta yell at me. God damn. Dark Verger activate Phoenix Chain. Fuck it. Dark Verger Phoenix Chain. Dark Verger Phoenix Chain. Damn, I see why he really wanted to use it. He only got one. Phoenix Chain. Get him, dog. I love Duel Wheel. Oh, he did not have another one. He just had one. Phoenix Chain. Oh, shit. Phoenix Chain. Fuck him. Fuck this guy. Phoenix Chain. Zao, thanks for the sub, my boy. 10 minutes ago. Sorry, I'm a maniac for that. Thanks for the sub, my boy. Fresh out of Coca-Cola, boys. Gotta drink the poor man's Coca-Cola. Water. Y'all ever wanna drink and had to drink the poor man's version, which is just water? Oh, this is Karakuri right here. Am I going first? Hell yeah!
Hell yeah! I love going first against Kamakiri because I know I'm going to clap their cheeks. I love going first against Kamakiri because I know I'm be getting in them guts for weeks. Yeah.
You see how we like to tilt the Kamakiri? We like to get right into those guts. Just get right in there. Get right into those guts. Make sure they know that they are loved and appreciated. Get right in those guts. That's all we got to do. When they're in the guts, they're going to say, I'm mighty thirsty. I'm quite thirsty for a Coca-Cola. And I'll say, have a poor man's Coca-Cola. Water. A what? A poor man's Coke. Water. Ah, I see. Quite right. Indubitably. Turn in. This man's about to get his life ended. Can't draw because of restart. He's going to summon his little searchy boy, and then he thinks he's going to get into more combos, but he's going to get tilted. He's like, summon my little searchy boy. Yeah. Target my little searchy boy. He dead. Oh, no, dog. In turn. Attack for 44. Boom. Unless he hate True Nays, then I'm like, chain. Now I got a big-ass monster. Ooh, here he is. Summon my searchy boy. Searchy boy searches. Go ahead and search, my search boy. Searchy boy searches for an awkward touch. I activate awkward touch. Go ahead and activate it. I'm sorry, your meta deck has disgusted me. I activate bad aim. You've fallen for the classic blunder and play the Karakuri deck. What is this? What? Hello? What is this? What? What the fuck? What is this? That's some bullshit. They just tried to steal this from me. They just tried to steal the election. Fool. 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 Never try to use a combo deck against a combo deck master. I will break your combo at its weakest points and get right into your guts. This is me in your guts. Like, no, not my guts. You see how that one little SR just fucked the whole deck up? Ended the whole man's life. Y'all like that, don't you? Bad aim. Pang. Ah. Let me tell you about a good card that tilts the meta that nobody's using right now. I'm going to tell you right now, my boy. I'm not even using it. That's how good it is. I'm going to tell you, but this is seriously a good card. Only for this meta. I'm going to tell you why. We got to go to counter. Bam. All right. Is this card right here? It's called... where is it? Here it is. Pulling the Rug. Negate the activation of effect monster whose activated effect on a normal summon, even itself, and destroy the monster that had the effect. This kills Alistair. It kills Stratos. It kills that little search man. It kills everything. Everything. Pulling the Rug is a card that we need to be playing in this meta right now. And I would say, if you don't got bad aim, try Pulling the Rug. It even stops Shiranui from getting started. So if you don't got bad aim, maybe try Pulling the Rug. Maybe. I thought I faced somebody cheating in the KC Cup too. I had a weird glitch and it just did a bunch of ridiculous stuff. And all of it, and I got kicked out and I brought back in. And then it was bananas. So I reported that guy. So yeah, Pulling the Rug is an excellent tech card. I think you should try it. I used it. It was working really well, but I was using it in the context of a counter trap deck. And that's kind of, you know, dubious at best, you know. But Pulling the Rug is a really good card. You should try that. If you haven't tried that, or you're looking for something to counter those guys, try Pulling the Rug. It's an excellent card. I recommend it. 4 out of 5 duelists recommend Pulling that Rug. So every combo deck likes the normal summon dependent. Yeah, it's pretty much everything out right now pretty much is doing that. So if you think about it, you know, Pulling the Rug is like, should be a high tier card that people should be playing, but people aren't playing it because, you know, I mean, honestly, you don't want to run the risk of playing Pulling the Rug and lose to something like Shiranui and be furious, or top deck Pulling the Rug and be furious. I understand. That's how I'd be disgusted. I'd be like, all right, I'm going to try Pulling the Rug. Situation never comes where I can pull the rug. So they just tried to steal the election. So look at this man. I'm a summon dog. I couldn't pull his rug, though. I would love to pull his fucking rug. Like, doink. Like, my rug. Fuck. I needed that. I don't give a fuck. Fuck your rug. Oh, my rug. Oh, sweet Jesus. Sweet baby Jesus. You know, it's going to be funny if I attack into that and he activates Ballista Squad and try to kill Summon Skull. That's going to be funny. Ooh. See, this is my... I love this. I love this combo. This combo sparks fucking joy. Watch this. I'm about to spark joy right now. Bliss. Hokkaido. Hokkaido. Hey. Get this shit off my board, please. Get it off my board. Get off my board, please. Come on, please. Lift up off my shit. Lift up off my shit. Birdman. Birdman. Fiendish Chain. They love trap. What's wrong with you freaks? Keep tying up this monster in Fiendish Chains. So disgusting. So disgusting. I might just attempt to attack for fucking game. I just might fucking try it right now. I just might fucking try it. Oh? Well? Oh, wait, no. That's not gonna be game. That's not gonna be game. That's gonna be a lot of damage, but that ain't gonna be game. And I could have actually destroyed the Fiendish Chain. Yeah, so I'm just gonna attack. I was saying, because at first I was like, yeah, that's not going to be game. That's just going to be a lot of damage. That's a lot of damage. Come on. That's a lot of damage. Everybody loves running that fiendish fucking chain. Actually, if he pulled the rug on me, I would have been so disgusted. That would have been insane. Summon, pull the rug. Oh my God, I just talked about that card. You ain't supposed to be using that. You're like, well, I am. I'm like, shut your bitch ass up. Playing with you. Yeah. No! He summoned a zombie skull? What happened to you? Look at him. He's like, brother, what has happened to you? He's like, I was corrupted by the meta, dog. Look what they did to me. Look what they did to me. Brother, you will be avenged, said Summon Skull. Said Summon Skull. Y'all remember them books? Oh no, said Billy. Impossible, said Jill. They were both surprised, because that shit that happened was scary. What? What are you doing with that monster? Oh, he's sacking him off. Oh God, that's filthy. You filthy duelist, you sacking off your monsters? Oh, you slut! You summoned two of the spiritual swords? Synchro summon, you filthy duelist! And show me the extent of your disgusting plays. Oh, he's gonna try to drop Big Boy Saga on us. Damn. Then there's only one chance. He's gonna buy Big Boy Saga, dog. Wait, what? That's not good enough. All right. Big Boy Saga Dog. Here it comes. Hakai Dog. Okay, shit. And he's got two in there. So you know he's gonna come from my fucking back row. I'll cut the damage by slapping down your monster. And he's sending two back, send two to the shadows. Come forth! Summon Skull to defend. Because you gotta defend. He's like, oh shit, set a back row. Set a little back row and then pass turn. Okay, go ahead. Dado. Nani? Damn, I need a second card to take him out. Damn. What's he having here? I still believe in my cards. I am in trouble. My wife put the dog out and he's knocking on the door. I passed turn. I didn't get as much protection as I needed, but. Oh, synchro summon. I'm dead. Unfortunate. Unfortunate. Let me see. Was this today? No, this was yesterday. So this today? This from here? Yeah. So da 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 da. No. Oh, it just turned. Oh, it's 12. Oh, it's past midnight. I was gonna say, what the fuck? Oh yeah, this was today. What was this? Oh, that guy hit me with that DD Crow. Yeah, he beat me with that DD Crow. Let me see. Oh, that guy, Wonder Wand. What's this guy have? Oh, and that was Steer Newbies. Okay. Unfortunate. If that one dude didn't hit me with that DD crawl, I wouldn't have lost that Shiranui duel. But fucking Shiranui, your shit gotta be on point to clap them boys. Calm down. Like, I did not get my power up card, so he lived too long and I died. You gotta kill Shiranui in like 2 turns. You can't let it, like, not even that sometimes. You gotta get them dudes out of there quick. If you don't get them, they will get. I love beating the shit out of Sartorius with this deck. I actually enjoy that thoroughly. I really enjoy fucking up Sartorius. I really do. I really do enjoy fucking Sartorius up. I do. I'm dead. Aqua Dolphin. Yeah, Aqua Dolphin would have won in that spot. Yeah, let me add some R6s up here. Actually, you know, real talk. I ain't even need that. Real talk. I should have put in that fucking Oh no, that would change the deck. You right. I'm dead. I did have this in it. Like, oh, actually, why did I change it? I forgot why I changed the extra deck. Originally I was running Winda. That's why I changed the extra deck. Oh yeah, I was wondering, like, how did all this random stuff get in here? And I was like, oh yeah, because I was playing Winda and I had space for Winda. Because originally I had this and Dolphin, and then I was just running it kind of like solitary style, like this, like one of everything. And I had this and Dolphin for those particular, all I have is the level 6 synchro situation. Yeah. But honestly, I never go into the spares. I always just keep the spares. I don't know why. I just keep the spares. I never go into the spares though, because typically either I, you know, win or lose, like, I'm out of there. Honestly, no, I'm not. I'm probably not gonna play anymore the KC Cup. I can't commit to it, man. Like, this is the problem. I know I want to play it and be competitive, right, and do as good best as I can. But I know also that I can't give it the time that I want to, like, you know, like, no life it, as they say, and get the points up. And I already spent the entire day, like I played last night and I spent the entire day not playing. So it's like, in my mind, I think, you know, I can't catch up to those top high levels. So it's no point, because that is the way I would play. I would play because I want to get to them top high levels, but I don't want to play that shit and then be thinking, oh man, I'm gonna hit it up and I'm gonna do this and that and da 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 da, and then I don't get to do it, and then I'm gonna be disgusted that I didn't get a chance to do it. And then I just don't want to be like that, man. I was like that before. Like, I'll tell you about the one time I tried to play in the KC Cup. No, it wasn't the KC Cup. It was the World's prelims. It was that big event, and this was years ago. And I was playing in it, and I was doing really well, and I looked at my ranking. I was top 75 in US at the time. And what happened was I got into a bunch of shit at my house, and I was like, hey, I need time to do this thing. And like, everybody was like, the fuck? And I was like, but I need this though. And at the time, it just was not good, and I just couldn't get it. And I was so salty that I couldn't do it. It just made me feel, I don't know, it made me just feel so bad. I just was like, I'm not gonna try unless I can really try. Unless I can really put 3 days of no life dueling to get the highest ranks. And it's like, if I can't do 3 days, to me it's like, what's even the point? Cause not like King of Games. King of Games, you can take that anytime, but you know, KC Cup is like, you know, if you either got the fucking time or you don't. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what I'm gonna do against this stupid shit. Cause I need to be able to beat this like now. And he blew up my fucking bad aim with his good aim. Lucky bastard. Him negate my effects is gonna suck ass. This card single summon target face up monster. And then those trolls and then return those targets to the hand. But you gotta target first. I don't know, man. I just kinda don't see the point. But honestly, at this point, I played up, I got a nice little record, and I just was like, I'm satisfied. Pass on this whole event. And if I do play it or pick it up again, I get to pick it up exactly where I left off because I did not touch it. And I'll be satisfied if I pick it up where I left off. So I'm weird. That's why I didn't touch it after I finished playing yesterday. And I didn't touch it today because I'm weird like that. Because I would literally be like, out of nowhere, it'd be like, Dan now has 2 hours of free time to himself. And I'll be like, all right, I'm going to play KC Cup for 2 hours. And I'll play KC Cup for 2 hours to see how far I can get. And if I get another 10,000 points, I'll be like, hell yeah. And then I'll say everything about it. But then if I play it for another 2 hours or whatever, and then I don't get, you know, any points or I break even or whatever the case may be, you know, I wouldn't feel no way about it. But I don't know, I'm weird because it's a tournament stuff and I feel like it matters, but I know it doesn't matter. But in my brain, it's like, it matters. So I just can't. It's almost like I gotta play this game with myself. It's kind of dumb. Yeah, Decade is a madman, man. And I mean, of all the people who can, like think about it. Like, how Decade has it set up, Decade can no life the game. Like, he should be able to no life the game. Like, this is his thing. This is what he does. And there's nothing wrong with that. And I think it's actually awesome. So, when Decade no lifes it, he should. And honestly, I saw Decade's video the other day, and he was talking about, what was he talking about? He was talking about playing to do like world championship and going to Japan or somewhere he was going. I don't remember where he was going. He's going out of town somewhere. He's going to do a thing. And when he was going to go out of town, basically, he was saying like he just wanted to be a world champion, and he was like, he doesn't really care about nothing else. Like, that's all he wants is to be a world champion. And I was like, oh, okay. Like, I thought that was admirable. And then he was honest, like, that's all I really fucking want. I don't care about nothing else. I thought that was cool. Like, you know, like if that's your goal, that's your goal. He's like, I just want to be world fucking champ. And I was like, hey, respect it. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to get out of this. I'm not drawing no power up cards, and he's got the shit locked down. And he blew up my bad aim, and it's starting to build up too much. I mean, I could mirror force it, but I mean, he had no incentive of turning that chick to attack position. So yeah, it is. Yeah. But yeah, man, I don't know. I just like the KC Cup and these world premiere tournaments, they bring up this like weird feeling in me. Like I want to compete more than anything, but I know that I just won't have the time in the end. And that's more depressing to me than like not playing at all or not having the right cards or not having the skill or not having or any of that. Or the meta too hard or any of that. Favorite deck is dead. Any of that is more depressing to me because I fully grasp and understand that I want this, but I don't have the time for this. And I have to literally choose not to have it. Like that kind of hurts my soul a little bit. Like, I know that sounds very weird, but it literally hurts my soul. Like, for me, it hurts my soul. Might not hurt your soul. You might not get it. Might not fully understand. But for me, it's painful just to know. Like, I'm not going to be able to participate in the way that I truly want to. So, you know, it hurts a little bit. So I don't indulge, if that makes sense. What? How dare you? Go, Forbidden Lunch! Ka-chink! Forbidden Lunch! Forbidden Lunch! KC Cup's not boring, man. KC Cup is exciting. Okay, so listen. I know that it's irritating to play against the same deck every time. Here's the value in playing against the same deck every time. When you know it's the same deck, you can make a strategy. You can use cards like Bad Aim. Like if you guys, like y'all know, like most of y'all have been around since like the beginning of Duel Links for me, right? Y'all know I don't like Bad Aim. Y'all know I don't play Bad Aim. But just because Karakuri is the top deck, I'm fucking playing Bad Aim. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's the only reason I'm doing it. Oh, look, this man. Oh, you want another boost? Why not? Have another boost. Scoodwink. Scoodwink. Skiddy-dee-dee-dink. I don't know, man. Hey, H, thanks for the shout out from Mexico, my boy. I don't know if y'all, it's hard to describe it. And I think this is the first time I've ever said it to anybody in real life, but like sometimes it kind of sucks, like being an adult, because you know you got to make that adult choice, you know? It's like, I want it, but I know I can't have, like, for example, I want a Friday night Yugi every fucking Friday. That'd be awesome, or whatever day it is, Thursday or whatever. But I can't do it. Like, I can't do it. I just don't got the time. And also COVID. So, you know, sucks. So it's very exciting. He says, my heart races every time I encounter a top tier deck. Yeah. And I'm playing Bougies. That's what I'm saying. It's like, you know, you're going to play top tier meta. You know you're playing Rogue. So every time I duel, it's like I feel it. That's why I say I'm getting serious. I feel my passion boil up. I feel the knot in my chest. You know what I'm saying? I feel the lump in my throat. I get nervous. You know what I'm saying? It's like that kind of stuff, like, motivates me to no life it. But I can't no life it because I got a life that will not allow me to no life it. My life is constantly holding me accountable. Like there's nothing I can do to know. There's the only way I could know life is that if I got everyone to comply that, okay, I'm gonna know life this, and I'm gonna need your help in carrying the burden of me playing 3 days of Yu-Gi-Oh and checking out. That's why I haven't done a 24-hour stream, because I can't do it. Maybe one day when that time comes. But it's gonna come with a great sacrifice, cause I wish I was a deadbeat and ain't have shit to do. But I mean, I got too much shit to do. But that's why like I said, I'm doing an official stream schedule, and I was gonna do 8:00, but that quickly changed to anytime before midnight for at least 2 hours. Y'all notice that? It used to be 8:00. But anytime before midnight, at least 2 hours. And that has changed from I might stream one day. Y'all know what I'm saying? BTZ, what's good, my boy? My favorite deck in the KC Cup right now that people are playing, that I think that people need to give more respect to, this deck, of course. And also Dragoonity. Because Dragoonity be out here, bro. But this one man, I had to execute him so out cold with this deck. He summoned two of them big ass 3,300 Dragoonity bastards. Put them on the field. God damn. I'm gonna get fucked. Get my shit. Damn. And he put out two of them big ass Dragoonity bastards, right? And when he did that, the funny thing about that was, he did that on the first turn. And I was like, I'm sorry, man. Fucking Brionic. Attack, battle tune for game. He was like, damn. I was like, I'm sorry, Doc. Oh, like, I'm so sorry. I was upset for him because it was fucking rude. I think this might be, what the fuck is, oh, it could be, actually, I don't know what this could be. I have no idea what this could be. We're going to summon, see if I get a response from his back row. So he's got a little back row action. He's only got 3,000 life points too, so. Oh, he's definitely got some, he's definitely got a hot back row back there. Hot, sexy back row. Hot, sexy back row for my Borky Lion. Just ripe for the negating. Here I come, dog. Here I come, dog. I'm gonna negate your shit, and I ain't playing with you. I'm gonna negate your shit, bruh. I'm gonna enjoy this. But Dragoonity should get some more respect, but I feel like they're getting trashed on constantly. Meme JRS, what's good, my boy?
Waffle Oats.
And Zamura, thanks for the subs. I'm all late. I did not hear the sound. I was talking. Ha! Get out of here.
Summon Skull! Lightning Strike!
I don't know if y'all remember, that's the sound he used to make back in Duel Monsters Yugi. Oh. I used to love Summon Skull. Yugi would be like, Summon Skull! Actually, I got a Summon Skull statue right here. Hold on. Y'all didn't know this.
Right here.
You can't see it. You can't even see it. I got these from an ancient store. You might have never heard of this store before. This store was called Toys R Us. It was a retail store that focused on selling only toys. I know that's crazy, but you know, they're gone. You know, they went the way of the Blockbuster, the Dodo Bird, and you know, maybe your dad, who knows. So here we go, my boy.
Summon Skull, Lightning Strike.
And then you got Blue Eyes White Beat Stick. Yes, look at that. Look at that. That's crispy, spicy. And then Koribo. I used to have these on my desk at work back in the day.
Back in the day. Back in the day.
They used to say, what are those? And I would say, ancient artifacts from a game played in ancient Egypt. They was like, wow, that's crazy, bro. They was like, ancient artifacts. I'm like, yes. Bujins is good, man. I got clapped by that direct attack Bujin version. Direct attack Bujins, I respect that. Like, you be expecting the old school Bujins, but direct attack Bujins just kill you. So I didn't know Toys R Us still existed. No, my boy, they didn't. When I got that, that was back when it was wild Toys R Us everywhere. And you know, you would go in there and you would get the sale. You go pick up your Skylanders. You know what I'm saying? Remember Kmart. Remember the blue light special, my boy? Too high. I wish. Oh, he's got that mat. Well, he's in for it. Sorry, my boy. I have the God hand. God hand. When you ask me about my hand, you will say, is it God? And I will say, possibly. And you will say, impossible, nani. You ask me, is it God? And I will say, yes. You would say, impossible, nani. Yes, it is a God hand. But do not fear it. Yes, it is a God hand. Your life points, I will sear it. Please summon the monster with low attack points. And try to smack my Archfiend. So I can use my tuning jeez. You'll never pass across my wall of skull. You will not stop my summer skull. Skiddy-ding. No. Ah.
I'll chain it.
Battle tuned, you ruined my surprise.
Battle tuned, can you see the power in his eyes? It summons Skull, and he's ready to clap your cheeks.
Hey, dab, thanks for that $2.99. I hit that dab in 2020, so what? I don't care. His name's Dab. See, I got a PS4 from Toys R Us. Shit! I got a PS5 from Toys R Us. That means I don't have one. Shit! This is the Kaiba. I summon Force Raider. Yo, okay. All right now. And what's crazy is, this is crazy. When you get as high as 44 and somebody meets you with 45 and you activate another battle tuned or a lance, they be so heated, bro. Can I get the Birdman? Damn, it's Lance. I'll take Lance though. Lance, Lance, Lance in your pants, Lance in your pants.
Summon Skull! Lightning strike! My power! Impossible. This beast. He found a way to chink inside of my skull's armor. And with 3,900 attack points, that's less than formidable.
Nani? Another one?
Damn. Does he plan on reducing my monster's attack points by sacrificing his own beast? He's a maniac.
Dotto!
I've already lost it. Damn. I'll have to attack with
Summon Skull! Lightning Strike!
No! Impossible! With 3,400 attack points, that's weak enough to kill my monster with a blue eyes white dragon equipped with Sword of Deep Seated.
If he does that, I'll cry.
Nani? Firestorm Vassal? Impossible. By using the Firestorm Vassal, he must plan to offer him as a tribute. But for what monster? There's not a single beast in his entire deck that can touch my Archfiend's Call, better known as Summon Skull. What? For a face down? And now he's getting in my jam jams. Damn, my hand's been exposed. Mo, my mighty mirror force. You bastard. Just wait until I draw the Birdman. I'll be clapping those cheeks post haste. Just wait till I get the Birdman. Come on. Can I get the Birdman? Can I get the Birdman? Or a trumpet. Dotto.
Summons Skull!
No! It's not supposed to be in my hand. I'm attacking your face down monster. What? The fuck is this? Evil Swarm Capilla.
When this card leaves the field, my opponent's card effect, you battle card effect, target one face-up monster your opponent controls and take control of it until your end phase. That's so random. That's a random. It say target, but I didn't even know this was a card. Where did this even come from? That's so random. What is this, a 6-star monster? 2050 defense, 2450 attack. That's so random. I don't understand. What is he doing? What are you planning? Can I get that Birdman? Dotto.
Bruh.
You against maniacs like this, as it's got bodies to just throw in front of your monsters constantly, turn after turn? this deck will slog. But it's funny because when you play against a combo deck, they don't have monsters to throw away. So if they start setting cards, you're breaking their combos. But for these maniacs, he's just like, I summon. And I'm basically neg wanting him every turn until he runs out of resources. Because, you know, he is too high after all. Now I have you. You've fallen for the classic blunder. You've run out of sacrifices. Looks like you'll be paying the ultimate price. I'm going to battle. Attack with Summon Skull! Lightning Strike! From my hand. Yeah. Boom. Huh. It is a monarch deck. You had too many sacrifices, boy. But he also didn't have any monsters to target. It's the ultimate protect the castle. That's why I also like using Wall of D in this deck. Cause if you notice, I'm not using the mirror force, but I'm using a whoa. Damn. Beat down too. I'm sorry, I had to dunk on you, my boy. Shit. Oh, this is the level up reward. That's why I don't have it. All right. I didn't know Igami had Evil Swarm cards. Okay. I did not know Igami had Evil Swarm cards. Edwin, what's good, my boy? Welcome back. That guy was, he's just playing a straight up maniac deck. Oh, some dude did give my gave my Archfiend's Call a good suck with a plasma. And I was like, oh, my life. Oh, no. You ever seen that meme where the face gets even more distorted and crazy? That's basically just me. I was like, oh no, this can't be. That was me. I was just like, ah! Just getting dead. And never saw anybody do that ever again. But that one guy did it and I was so salty because at that point, I had so many outs to it, I just didn't draw a single out. And I felt so bad. I was so tilted, I had to stop dueling for a little while. Casey Cup, when you get tilted and you lose, you gotta stop playing. Bruh, I hate this though. I hate this thing. This guy, this shit is annoying, bruh. I summon my big ass statue. My big ass statue is gonna do a big ass statue thing. You know why? Why is that, Odeon? Because it's what big ass statues do, homie. I'm like, yeah, okay. Now, big ass statue, use your effect and destroy a card on the field, dog. Good thing my trumpeter can put down the trumpet at any time to play the Forbidden Lands. Chink! What? Impossible! He'll get the effect off twice in just one turn? No! What happened? Did he like mess up the chain or something? Like what? 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 Huh? I don't get it. What happened? Did the chain mess up or something? It's a monster now. Duh. Okay. It's a monster now. It's a monster now. It's a monster now. I forgot. They literally move it out of the space and make Witch Rider. Bruh. Really? Oh God, oh my Jesus, oh my guts, what the fuck, Odion! I wasn't ready for that deck. I was not ready. I was not ready. Oh my god, he's running Obelisk, fucking Uriah, Lord of Searing Flames. Oh my god. Oof. Oh Lord. Oh, he's running. Oh. What? Have you ever seen that in your life? What is that? Have you ever seen that before? The fuck was that, bro? You've got to be kidding me. Look at this dude. All right. So we're going to do one play and try to secure the field. And then the second play is going to be Brionic for game, I hope. Come on out. Summon Skull. Yeah, it's not a spell or trap. It's a god. But you, so you're saying Cosmic Cyclone won't work on it? Yeah, it will work on it. Okay. Oh, no. I'm going to enjoy this. Do, 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 do. Wow, 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 wow. Gale Wellwing. He's like, wait, how come that effect didn't work? All right. Synchro summon.
All right now. Rock your range hour. Make it rain on me. Make it rain on me.
Oof. Can I get that big oof there, buddy? Can I get an oof? Can I get an oof? Oh, wait, no. Oh, no, he said he can't. Oh, wait, no, what? You played the Lance. But it says once per turn, this card cannot be destroyed by spell or traps. How can you not read your own shit? I can make a mistake and fuck up and not read it. You can't do that. I can do that. You can't do that. This man didn't read his own shit. What the fuck? What the fuck? Huh? Ooh. Come on out. Summon Skull. You weren't expecting this, were you? They never do. Fiends always expect to be oofed by Summon Skull. Oh, my guts, Dodo. My guts, my pretty guts. You know you got in my guts there. Pretty nasty. Summon a monster. My guts, I can't believe you got right into them. But I still got plays. Brionic. No. With Brionic's effect, I can get rid of both of your monsters for good. Now, Brionic, smack down that monster and force him to brick. Attack. You lose, Luna. You're gonna brick. Oof. Yeah. Dado. You now have permission to wet yourself. I'm gonna attack, dog.
Oof. Go ahead. Draw your last pathetic card so Brionic can end this match. Good. Prepare yourself. Brionic will use his special ability. By using Brionic's skill, I can discard one card from my hand and return one monster of the field to yours. And don't expect to survive. Brionic has powers that you could never understand, Blackwing Duelist. Attack Brionic!
That'll do, dog! Now my Brionic's gonna get a boost!
Yes.
Thank you. 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 Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
He did all that shit in the beginning. He deserved to get clapped. Oh, you know, let's play some Subterra. That should be fun to play. Because nobody's expecting that either. It's a nice little tilt deck. Lumis and Umbra getting in there.
Summon Skull!
What?
Huh? Huh? Impossible!
Why, Jesus? Why? The mass beast and no mirror force? Oh, he put three cards into that. Oh my god. The mass beast. Oh, it's oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Ah!
Oh.
Skiddy-dee-dee-ding.
Perfect card. Hold this forbidden lands. Now you hold the L. Then I activate painful decision. Because I took 3,300 points of damage, I can do this. Now I call forth the Angel Trumpeter. Now, Dark Verge arises from the grave. Come forth, my beast. Now, I'll execute a move known as a Synchro Summon. Come on out, Brionic! Brionic, rise up, my beast. Blow back my enemies as I clap the enemy cheeks in which we need to gain victory. Brionic effect. Yeet. 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 Nani? Impossible! He dodged my move. But I've got two bad aims to clap his cheeks. Cheeks.
This Brionic has 4,200 attack points. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? You ain't gonna do nothing. Set a card and die? Sure. Play no cards and die. Great. Mass tribute. I thought you need to have a munchdown. That maniac, I can't use it, but I can use this. Bryonyx of it! By discarding a card from my hand, I'll send your beats back to yours. Now prepare yourself to feel the icy sting of Bryonyx's touch. Bryonyx, direct attack! You couldn't run forever. Bryonyx. Mass tribute, you maniacs. You maniacs. Dwing. Mass tribute. Mass tribute, dog. Ah. Crazy. Mass tribute. Yeah, all right. I guess. I mean, okay. I mean, hey, I play Madman stuff all the time. I love using Bryonyx, man. Bryonyx battle tuned is so whack. But it's effective as fuck. Bryonyx battle tune for game? Like, oh, really? Yes, bro. Yes. Yes. Like, no. Not Bryonyx battle tune. Yes, Bryonyx battle tune. Oh, this is fuck. It's invoke. And this isn't an invoke hand. I'm not ready. Oh, actually, we can fuck them up with Forbidden Lands. I'm not ready for this. This is an invoke hand. Hey, oh, that was you, Omega. I'm sorry, I talked all this shit. But thanks for dueling, my boy. I was only talking shit in jest. If I'm actually dueling y'all, I'll be feeling bad. I'll be talking shit. I'm just dueling. And I was just talking shit in jest. I did not actually mean the terrible things I have said. Forgive me. Forgive. See, this is what I'm talking about. The weird duality of streaming and dueling. It's also personal, yet also impersonal. It's just so weird. Yes. Throw Cosmic Cyclone off the top of the deck. That's the card I would love to see fall. Yes. Discard a card. And special summon. All right, it's fine. I was like, no, I'm sorry. I was just playing. Use the effect, boy. Use the effect, you know you'd love to. Use the effect. Do it now. Use it. Mill the cards. You know you want to mill. Get greedy and mill the cards. Do it. Do it. Stop thinking about it and do it. You know you want to mill. You're looking for something. No! 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 Power of the Guardian. How about you guard this? Bad aim. You should have tried to bait it out. You maniac. Power of the Guardian. Take this. Take this. Power of the Guardian. You maniac. What the fuck? Come on, boy. Come on, boy. Come on, boy. Give it to me. Come on. Oof. I've only got one chance, apparently. I've only got one chance, apparently. I draw. Fool, you've fallen for the classic blunder. By summoning the Angel Trumpeter, I can use the power of my Dark Verger in the graveyard. And now that Dark Verger has joined the powers of the Angel Trumpeter, I shall summon forth. Say with me.
Summoned Skull.
Now, normally, my summon skull would not be able to defeat your Judgment Dragon, and I would assume that judgment had been passed. But not today. Go, summon skull, lightning strike!
A battle-tune dog.
My skull's getting a boost, and you're going down. Rise up, my beast. Yugi! You won't survive. No! Fortune Lady! I forgot about her! Damn.
Go ahead and slice me some cheese. I forgot about that shit. Jesus Christ. I forgot.
He's like, fool, do you remember? When I tried to equip my witch with Power of the Guardian, you destroyed it with your card. I'm like, so? That means I can use it to summon from my graveyard, and I have a monster that spellcasters in my grave.
I'm like, okay.
Go! Attack!
That's how I imagined he was doing over there. All that facial expressions and everything, even going, I would imagine that. Yes, he was doing it. Damn it, Anamana play, they gonna make me go fucking second.
Yup,
you know, I'm gonna get him. Maybe not. Shit. Oh no, they don't Anamana play. What? This ain't no Anamana play. What the fuck? He ain't Anamana playing no games, boy. He like, I ain't Anamana playing with you, boy. Oh, shit. Like, set. Fuck you. All right, sir. I can set three in the back row as well. I just can't set up my fucking graveyard like you, you lucky son of a bitch. I want to set my shit up.
I mean, damn.
Gazuki's effect.
Fuck. This is crazy. Hey, I had to get a little poor man's Coca-Cola, and I'm about to go get me a dual fuel.
Let me grab me a dual fuel.
Mom, can you make me a little bit of dual fuel? Sure, honey. Would any of your hot friends like one too? Guys, my sexy mom is asking, would you like any dual fuel?
Yeah. Ooh.
Sure, do that.
How about this? Some dual fuel. It's called Mirror Force.
That's why I play it. That's why I play it, boy. It's called Mirror Force. You about to get the dual fuel. You about to catch my dual fuel. Don't scoop, cause you deserve it. Here come the archfiends call. You about to get the dual fuel. Are you ready for this dual fuel? Go! Summon skull! Lightning strike! You're about to catch a dual fuel. That's literally all the KC Cup was. Mirror Force, Summon Skull game. I go second. Bryonic game. Back and forth like that. And every now and again, we would stop and have a Dragon Ball ZX clash. And we would go back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. And that was kind of like an anomaly. But it was more of like, do you got the big stick or do I got the big stick? Did you swing the big stick and miss? Or did I swing it and connect? Yeah, you need formula synchron. Tony, my boy, we've been clapping like that all day. Where you been at? You ain't seen them Bryonic attack for games. You ain't seen them, my boy. That's my favorite. Oh, shit. Cyber Dragon. First? Damn. I like going first against them and summoning Brocky Lions and seeing the look on their face. Set my little card and then just be like, fuck, I'm going to lose. But yes, you are. Damn. I hate it when it comes like this. It's like the Omega Brick. But it's a good first turn play and then like a second turn follow up. So it's not terrible, but it's just not the best. Oh shit, he went and got that. That means one thing, setting three in the back row. Oh shit, he's going in right now. Oh fuck, Cyber Style. Is he really going? He's going the distance. No. Not on the first turn, you madman! Don't do it! All right, I'd love to draw that counter. Dodo. This is gonna be me in his guts. Pause. Stop. 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 I'm dead. Here we go. Oh, I'm gonna get him. It's Summon Skull. He's back. And this time, he's got 2,500 attack points ready to clap your cheeks.
Now, go Summon Skull. Lightning Strike.
You fool. You don't think I anticipated such a move? Come forth.
Rise up. Summon Skull.
Get ready. You're about to get pounded like 1999.
My Summon Skull attacks.
Are you ready for this clap?
It seems like we're going into damage, so I'll use this. Battle tuned. My beast getting a boost, and you're going down.
Summon Skull! Lightning Strike! Only YouTuber in history clapping with vanilla Summon Skull. God.
Summon Skull in your gut. Lightning Strike. Oh my God. Y'all, if you saw that video I put up earlier, I literally used Forbidden Lands to prevent my opponent from getting rid of their monster so that Summon Skull on the next turn could kill it for game. Baba Booey. Baba Booey. He did not see that coming. He thought, haha. He's probably thinking, haha. With my monster, I'm definitely gonna be able to get you now, boy. Wait. What? Like, my luck, 999. Hey. Thanks for that sub, my boy. Wait, oh, this is negative 999. Shit! If your luck is that bad, my boy, hold on. I'm gonna just give you a little bit of my luck. I can't be giving you all my luck right now. I'm trying to go king of games. Can't be giving you all my luck, boy. That's what the KC Cup is all about, man. Making them kind of plays, bro. But I'm not even in the KC Cup right now. But I'm saying, like, that's like all the KC Cup is doing that over and over and over and over and over and over again. It's a lot, man. It's very intense. Dante Bell, what's good? Thanks for the Nunny. Are we gonna have fun with you? Are we gonna get you? Are we gonna get you, homie? Yeah, let's see. Come on, let's go, Alistair. Let's do it. Uh-huh, set that card. Set that card, homie. Set it. You're not activating invocation? You're not playing invocation because you know I'm gonna give you that lance, all right? I see you using that spyware. Spy on this. I draw a card. It's going down. Did you know you're going down, my boy? I summon Angel Trumpeter, and the Dark Verger appears from the graveyard. Did you know this, Alistair? Cornodia. How about this? I'm gonna activate the Forbidden Lands and stop you from destroying my beast or destroying my combo. Now, your Alistair will pay the price of your arrogance. Now I synchro summon to a monster most powerful. Here's the fan favorite, dog. Here's the fan favorite. White Aqua Dolphin! White Aqua Dolphin, special effect. White Aqua Dolphin cuts the attack of your bitch. Take that, Alistair, dog. Oof. Sorry, Alistair. Looks like you're going down. Summon Skull. Lightning Strike. Yeet. How did it feel to die in damage, Alistair? Here I come, my boy. You whoop! Oh. Damn. Defense mode I go. All right now. All right now. Defense mode. Damn. Tis five. There isn't a single beast in your entire deck that you can make to wipe out the power of Summon Skull. There isn't a single combo in your entire deck with enough prowess to clap Summon Skull. Reveal. Bad aim. Fool. Did you think I'd come unprepared to clap your cheeks? Now perish. I said perish. Perish! Yes. Nani? Oh no! I forgot, dog. He did not normal summon. I forgot. But that doesn't matter.
Nani?
You're summoning a big fat cockatoos? Well, that's not gonna help you at all.
My summoned skull will clap those cockatoos cheeks.
And you'll be going down.
Dodo.
I'll be clapping those cockatoos cheeks right now. I'm coming over there to clap those cockatoos cheeks. Bring that cockatoos cheeks over here. Give me those cheeks. Give them to me. Give them up.
Karibo. Why, Jesus? Why, Jesus?
This man,
Karibo. Karibo-ku.
No. What? Molten, what did it do? Send two larvals from your deck to the graveyard. What? California forest fire. What? When this card is sent to the graveyard, if you have a larval monster in the graveyard, other than this card, you can send one larval monster. Okay. Bruh. Oof. That is so random. What? My Jimmy Jams. I'm tilted. What the fuck? What? I gotta see this deck now. What the fuck? He just had that in his deck, not in his hand. He didn't have any larvals in his hand. He just threw random larvals. He just had a random larval spell with random larvals in his deck and threw that shit out randomly. Come forth, summon skull. You gonna kamikaze with me, dog? Huh? You kamikaze with me, dog? Huh? Oof! He said, "Sure thing." Ah! Ooh! Get a ding. God damn.
I'm dead.
I'm dead outside that larval play, but I gotta see this shit. His deck says, his name says random. I literally played Karibos, Alistair's, and back row. Until he popped this shit off. This is the most bullshit, convoluted shit I've ever seen in my life. Just play Magician Girls.
I'm dead.
I guess he was bored. Like, fuck it, I'm gonna just throw some larvals in here. Fuck it. Fuck it, I'm gonna just put some larvals in this shit. Don't give a fuck, it's Alistair. He said he's playing Skill Voker. Fuck it. I'm gonna just put some larval in this shit. I don't give a fuck. Fuck it. I'm just put some larval in this shit. I don't give a damn. Just play Magician Girls. I'm playing Magician Girls, dog. Here I come. He said it was a funny MST though. Yes, that was a really good MST. And them Karibos got my guts. Can't even lie. Not gonna lie, Karibo clapped my total cheeks. I'll do easy player's turn when your opponent activates card effect that targets our right. Not gonna lie, he clapped my cheeks. Number 15. Angel Trumpeter. P People wouldn't normally summon Angel Trumpeter in attack mode, but YTDan would do it. He'd do it anytime. Number 17. I'm dead.
Oh! You fiend! Forbidden Lands! Though you tried to destroy my monster with your chain disappearance, my Forbidden Lands will give this fiendish monster a second chance at life. Now live, my verger!
Live!
Damn, I hate fucking magician girls. I didn't really mean it when I told that guy to play fucking magician girls. God damn it. I actually did not mean it. I did not. Oh, hi, Mark. I guess I'm gonna have to go in the summon skull. Because unfortunately, you know, it's shit going down. Here it is. He's the call of the Archfiend. I hope this back row wasn't a cosmic fucking cyclone. That would suck. I'm attacking with the call of the Archfiend. Summon Skull! Wait. You're changing to defense position? And doing what? Summoning a monster for fucking free? That's pretty fucking good, right? I'll continue the attack and wipe out that monster. Be gone, fairy girl. I can't believe it. Good job, I guess. I can't believe it. He did it. He targeted my back. I shouldn't have said it. Fuck. Alrighty. Do your worst. God, this fucking annoying as shit. Lord. That's dead. God. Annoying as shit. Bullshit. Absolute bullshit. Good old Alistair coming out of nowhere. Here I come, dog. Get ready for some clappy clappy. Yeah, okay. Get ready for some clappy clappy, dog. It's Alistair. You fucker. So lame. Fuck. Fucking fuckhead. Fuck. All right, give me that. I know what I gotta draw to win, but I mean, goddamn. Ugh, shit. I've only got one shot at this, and I must draw it. The roo. What? No! No! Painful decision. Yeah, I'm on the ladder. This is ladder. This is ladder. This is ladder. This maniac. I shouldn't have set the battle tune, but I set the battle tune. Not anticipating a whatchamajig, a Ballista squad. Like, some people play Ballista squad in that deck, but not everybody. I was not anticipating a Ballista squad or even a cosmic cyclone. I was anticipating something else, so that's a oof. What? Rank down. All those claps I've been doing, and now you spit in my eye with a rank down against a 30 card after Phoenix. Don't insult me. My Akashi. No. This deck is annoying too, actually. Very annoying. Yeah, I hate bricking on this, but honestly, this extra card is only in here because I got to get the combo and Brionic fodder. What? My Akashi slash vampire? Okay, this is spicy. So how you been, my boy, long time? He says, kind of fell off Duel Links. Said, just stay subscribed to you. Hey, I appreciate it. Says, I don't even know what's meta, my boy. Well, depends on when you dropped out, my boy, Manuel. And also, thanks for the 10 bones. Still sure knew he still invoked. This is actually a spicy innovation I've never seen before. And I'm excited to cheese it up. Whoa. Vampire Grace, your Grace. Traps? No. You can take my humble mirror force.
Out the door.
I know what your deck is all about, so I'm activating the painful decision. I'll make a choice to take you down. Here it is. It's the Angel Trumpeter. By adding it to my hand, I'll add your cheeks to the graveyard. I summon the Angel Trumpeter. The Angel Trumpeter plays a seductive song of doom, which summons Dark Verger. When Dark Verger and Angel Trumpeter join forces, they can synchro summon into a powerful fiend. I'm calling out all the archfiends.
All the archfiends. Get your hands up. Put up in your claws. Get in those.
I don't even know what rhymes with claws.
Gauze.
See, that's why I'm not a rapper. I'm a duelist. But you know, you could be a dueling rapper. See, you know, that could be your thing right there. I'm not a rapper. I'm a duelist. I just do the cool shit. Ooh. See, you could be that guy, bro. That could be your gimmick, bro. And then you can play gimmick puppets too, bruh. You're a god. I lost that last duel because I didn't respect the battle tune. I'll never make that mistake again. Battle tune, I'm respecting it and putting it on my most powerful monster that can't be targeted by your deck that targets, because I know you targets because you play vampires. Take this. Oh wait, what? Oh, I forgot his life points was low. I could have just killed him with Lance. I forgot that his life points was reduced because of all the vampire effects. Oof. Oh well. Why don't you get rid of a card? Why don't you die? What? I'll throw all those mirror forces away. I totally forgot that his life points was below. Like, as soon as I looked at his life points and it said 600, and you go like, say what? And I just forgot that his life points was, like, you know, not 8,000. I mean, not 8,000, 4,000. I forgot that these cards take life every time they summon. I can see why, you know, in a meta where Cosmic Cyclone is one of the most relevant cards and you kind of have to play Cosmic Cyclone to get rid of back row to be good, I can see how a deck like Vampires is just, like, not worth it. Because all their effects target, on top of targeting, all the cards cost life points. Like, bring it. Bring it. Oh, my God. Oh my God, bruh, talk about paying for misdeeds, yikes. Bruh. Homie. Fellas. Homie. Ooh. Oof. Oof. I didn't expect it. Oof. I wasn't paying attention. See, this is what I'm talking about. I can't do stuff like this if I'm playing KC Cup. I wouldn't have made that mistake playing KC Cup. But bullshitting talking to y'all, I'll make this mistake. I'll make it every single fucking time. Bullshitting talking to y'all, I'm like, yeah, ha, ha, ain't no thing. Ha, ha, what? That's literally me, like, ha, ha. Talking shit ain't no thing. You fool. You fallen for the classic blunder. Although your vampires have sucked away my mirror of horse, you still have one mirror of horse in with a oh no! Fool. Did you know when two people activate forbidden lands at the same time, both forbidden lands cancel out each other and the mirror of horse? Okay. I'm dead. Oh. Well, that's the end of that chapter. Rank up foiled. This man was at 100 life points, bro. He was at 100 fucking life points. He plays one plasma. He's not running Mayakashi vampires. He's just playing vampires with a plasma in it. If I had caught wind of that, I would have been able to play better, but I did not catch wind of that or was paying attention. So I failed. And this is why, you see, I got to get in the zone and play perfect against these top tier decks. But then you come across and you play some legend, shoot shit with the boys, this happens. Dub, 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 oof. Triple oof. Should have only been a double oof, but it became a triple oof. Just that quick.
Can I get a triple oof, extra large, two number nines, extra dead? Can I get it?
So it's still funny as hell. So stop watching right around the time you announced you were about to be a father. Damn. That was 5 months ago. Oh, wait, no. You said about to be a father? Oh, no. That was a year ago, actually. Because 9 plus 5. Yeah, that's a year ago. That's crazy. It's crazy to think a year ago I was just some guy. Now I'm some guy's dad. Yeah. That's cool. From some guy to some guy's dad. Nice. I think about that a lot, actually. The Aster always equals plasma. True. But again, I was not in competitive mode. Like, honestly, like I play this so casually, like a maniac when I'm playing Duel Links with you guys. That when I actually get serious, it's just like laser focused, and I can't commentary when I'm laser focused like that. It's just playing the game, looking at it. All right, next game. All right, next game. But yes, if I knew I was gonna be able to go all the way, I would definitely do it. But I think honestly, what I'm gonna do is, this is what I'm likely gonna do. Cause right now I'm looking, if I look at this right, you go to the rankings, right? You got global rankings. I'm at 6,000. And let me see. Global rankings, I'm at 6,000. And the ranking rewards for 5,000 is 2 SR prismatic tickets. Oh, I clicked it by accident. Damn it. 2 SR prismatic tickets. And I don't really care about anything here, I don't think. Yeah, it's not really anything that I really want in this at all. Yeah, there's not anything here. And then top 5,000. Yeah, top 5,000, 2 SR prismatic tickets. So in order for me to get a UR ticket, I have to be top 500. is that worth it? You know what I'm saying? Like, if I want another super rare prismatic, is that worth it? It's not worth it. It's not worth it. I played some competitive games. I got a nice little streak. I'll just sit there and just collect my shit. Because the prizes from 20,000 to 30,000, the prizes, period, from the lowest fucking prize all the way up to top 500 to 1,000, it's the same shit. So none of this is worth it. None of this is worth it. It's not worth the time. It's not worth the stress. It's not worth the effort. So let's say you play through all this shit and you get number one. The number one spot is the only spot that's worth it. And the only way you're going to get number one is if you try to know life. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, for me, somebody who would really want, who really wants to know life for 3 days, but cannot know life for 3 days, it's not worth it, bro. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. I can spend my time doing anything else. And I mean, y'all can let me know. Y'all can let me know if y'all, if I'm just weird about this, but I personally think that a UR dream ticket, I mean, if these were dream tickets, okay, that'd be different. Okay, you handed out fucking dream tickets, let's go. I'm about to get a knife. We about to fucking duel, like, we about to really duel, like. But look at this, UR dream ticket. What the fuck? What, I want a Dinotherium? I got a bazillion of those, prismatic, actually. What, I want a prismatic Meowth? Okay, well, that's actually kind of cool. But I don't want to duel for my soul for it. God damn. There's nothing here at all. There's nothing here. And I mean, honestly, there's nothing here that's really competitive. Like, what's competitive? Dark Magician. Okay. Thunder Dragon Dark. All right. This bitch, maybe. Dark Magic Curtain. There's nothing worth anything. So, you know what I'm saying? It just is not worth it. It's like nothing is worth it. Now, let me tell you what would make this worth it. If they replaced a ticket with $5, it just said 5 USD. Instead of saying 6 UR, it said 5 USD. It would be worth it. $5 is tremendously worth a tremendous amount of money in compared to all prizes. So if $5 would trump all these prizes, except for the WCS invitation, it's no point in doing this. Also, you get this little sexy banner, okay? And you get the little notification squad, right? That's kind of cool, I guess, the prestige. But if you're not, if your prestige does not say top 100 and above, you know, it's not all that great. I don't know. I just think that it's just not worth it. You know what I'm saying? Or if they were, or if this was 6 dream tickets, I mean, think about how amazing the prize pool would be if the prize pool said 6 UR dream tickets, 6 SR dream tickets for the top 500. Top 500 gets nothing but dream tickets. That would be worth it, because if I fought and went into the KC Cup stage 2 and no lifed it and lost, I could get my value out of the dream tickets, which technically are at least tens of 20s of dollars in value. But if I get these fucking SR UR tickets, there is no value in this, because the prizes is shit that you can get from packs. I mean, like packs of the game, you know? So if stuff you can get from the game, it's worth zero, because you can always get it. And just because it's shiny doesn't mean shit, because ain't nobody summoning the cyber fucking tutu. Where your cyber tutu at? You don't know. You don't even know if you got one. How many cyber tutu you got right now? Tell me. Oh, you a Yu-Gi-Oh fan? Name all the cards. I'm just saying, it's just not worth. And then on top of that, then they shower you with gold,
tremendous amounts of gold.
They can do nothing. Nothing. So the only value I have in playing stage two, I only have one mission in playing stage two every time I play. And this is literally my only mission. And this is my real talk. My mission is to create a deck that other people can play so that they can get the gems and shit that they want. Cause other people don't got meta stuff, or they don't want to play meta stuff and they want to do something else. I just make a deck that works against the meta so other people can get in there, and that's it. Outside of that, I don't really have no goals for KC Cup. Cause kind of similar to how Decay said, all he wanted to be was world champion. I mean, shit. I don't think I've ever wanted to be world champion of anything. I don't think so. I don't think I've ever thought like, man, I really want to be world champion. That never interests me. But what I would love to do is compete at the highest level. I want to do that. I want to compete at the highest level for my fans, but I can't do that because there's only one spot on this. Or if it was three spots, you know, anything, there's one spot requires a no life contribution. And I can't make the sacrifice. Here's another random rant classic. Hey, Manuel, you came back for the perfect rant classic, my boy. Just in time, my boy. Mitishi? Nagda? Thanks for the subscription, my boy. I appreciate it. Said maybe for a few people. Said, but I imagine a majority of those people are willing to spend even if they don't have everything. Yeah. I mean, people are willing to put it in, my boy. Say gold is good for filling the bank and just sitting there. Is it just like real life? No, in real life.
There is no gold. Never has been.
Never has been. So look at this. Okay. So this is what I'm saying. Oh, this is Steven Freshly? Is my boy really on there? Hold on. That's it, Steve Freshly. Hold on. That's it, Freshly. Is that my boy? Hold on. I saw Steve Freshly. Hold on. Fuck. Hold on. I'm gonna play no games. My boy on here. Hold on. Hold on. Damn! Go ahead, Mr. Freshly. Clap them cheeks, boy. Steven Freshly. Hey, that's what's up. Go ahead, Mr. Freshly. Shout out to the boy. My boy, Steven Freshly. Is he streaming? Let me see. Shout out to the boy, Steve Freshly. Hold on. Let's look my boy up. Damn. I don't see him on here. I thought he streamed sometimes. Could have sworn he streamed on something. I did not see him. But shout out to the boy, Steven Freshly. Clapping them goddamn cheeks. Now see? I love it. I mean, unless that's not him. But I mean... Oh, wait. Hold on. Unless it says Freshy. Maybe it might not be him. It's a fresh, or maybe he didn't have enough letters. I don't know. I had to hit him up. Like, I don't know. I think that's him though. But what I do is, like, honestly, I'd be like this. Okay, so look, this is the top North American ranks. And I've done this multiple KC Cups. I just won and got my DP to a certain level and just parked it and just stopped playing. And then, you know, oh, he stopped streaming altogether. But it does say freshy. Said they should stop, like they should bring Zone for 5Ds. Oh yeah, I see. I know that character. Yeah. I think so. Like, look, North America top 500 is 13,000 points. 13,000 points, and then the leap from him to top 100 is 20,000 points. That's how hard it is to get 10K points in this meta. I don't mind parking it at 13 and just waiting. Because look at this. This dude is barely hanging the fuck on. He could get sent to the shadows at any moment. Any moment. I'm sitting at 13. I'm chilling. And then you'll get your shit back and they'll be like, hey, congratulations. You're number one in the whole thing because the top 10 people cheated and and everybody else fell off the map. And you're the only one left. Da-na-na-na-da-na. Oh, you said Freshie's on Twitch now. Oh, okay. I got to go check the boy out then. But hey, he's getting, hey, maybe he's going in for number one. Like, you know, that's the whole thing. If you can go, like, what was number one actually? Number one was 50,000, I think, globally, wasn't it? He's at 40. I mean, he's there. Global ranks. Oh, 60,000. This guy's named Payne. I would be so mad. Like, how's he under him just one duel? Like, look at these points. Like, honestly, like, in my mind, this is how I think about these points. And let me know if y'all think about these points the same. These points represent pretty much a set of 10 duels, right? So if you got 10,000 points, you were able to clear, for example, if like I got 13,000 points. I was able to clear a set of 10 like this, right? Reasonably without losing too much. So that allows me to advance, right? Regardless if I streak 7, 6, 12, or whatever, as long as I'm doing this, getting a set of 10 that's all yellow, then I'm gonna get 10,000 points, right? So that means you can lose maybe 2 or 3 times, maybe. I'm not sure. Maybe 2 or 3 times. Cause you can lose 2 times. Yeah, you can lose maybe once or twice, actually. You got to be at least 80% because you lose about 400 to 500 points when you lose. So, and then it gets even more ridiculous when you get closer to the end. You know what I'm saying? So when you get to the end of like the actual like you get into the upper echelons to 60. You're taking like you lose, you take a lot of damage, I think. Like, I think they take like 1,000 or more, maybe. But they take a lot of points off when you lose this high. But if you're losing at 10, you know, you're losing like 500, 400, something like that. So basically, these people that have the 60K, you gotta think about it like this. These guys are playing a block of 10 duels and losing maybe 2, maybe less. In a block of 10 duels. And if you lose like 3 duels, your block of 10 starts over. So that's how I think about it if I'm compartmentalizing my time. And like I showed you before, the type of deck I was playing this exact deck, right? And I've told y'all before, look at my time, because this deck plays very fast. So look, 530, 534, 540, 543, 546, 552, 555, 604, lost, but 604 to 613. This duel took me almost 10 minutes to lose. But you see all these other games, I win in 2 to 3 minutes. So think about that. In your head, how many minutes do you need to no life Duel Links and win to get 60,000 points or more? If your deck can win in 2 minutes. Now, what was this guy said? Top KC player. Let me see. I think let me look at this replay. I think I can, oh no, I gotta keep that one. This is Roy21. Let me see. I think I can just go ahead. I think I can still got Roy21 on here. Let me see. Oh, actually, I can delete that one. All right. I'm going to take a look at this real quick. This took me longer I'm going to take a look at this because I don't even remember. And I bet you it was like invoked or something. Let me see what this was. I don't remember what deck this was, but I'm pretty sure whatever it was held me up. Said you need 100K to actually win. All right, so if you need 100K to actually win, and it takes you 3 minutes to get, I don't know, to get through a duel, and then you need to do that 10 times, that's 30-minute blocks where you expect to win. And if anybody takes you off of that schedule, you lose. Well, not lose, you lose in time. All right, so let's see. Oh, I was playing Magician Girls. So yeah, it's, yeah, this shit is like, let me see, I gotta put top down for this. I was playing against Magician Girls and I lost. Like, he Kanadia, I lanced. Yeah, got through, then he Ballista Squad. Then he brought back the Kanadia. Yeah, so that normally, like, when they do that, that fucks me in the game. And then his second turn is Alistair. And then, see, this is where I would actually, like, honestly, if I took out these Drowning Mirror Forces and played Pulling the Rug, I would actually been able to beat this guy, which is why I was looking at Pulling the Rug and was thinking about that being a viable competitive option. But Pulling the Rug would have stopped him right there. And then I think I even went for the OTK, and he must have had something to stop me from killing him. Oh, no, he banished old boy, and I couldn't do the OTK. Oh, right. Yeah, he banished it. And then I just set it face down to try to surprise him and go 38. But I think he can go, like, beyond 38. Oh, he summoned Cocytus. And then it was hard to kill it because he banished my Verger. And ironically, a lot of times people don't banish Verger. Like, people, like, don't play Whatchamajig. I Battletoon, Cowboy, and smacked. Damn. Draw Sense Dark. Yeah. And then I got oofed by another Alistair. Like, fucking Alistair Brigade. It's like, what do you do against that? I remember. This is where I took the fucking Alistair out. I mean, not the Alistair out. This is where I took the Cowboy out because I was furious. I was furious. I remember that. Because I remember my mindset. Okay, this was my mindset. I just beat this Rio 21 guy. I had just beat this guy. And I beat this guy, I was thinking, oh, hell yeah. This is I got what it takes to make this deck's got the right stuff, is what I said. So I was winning. I was winning, right? And I got to this point, I think this is 7 victories. Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I got 7 victories. And I noticed it. And I said, holy shit, I got 7 victories. If I can just get 3 more games, I can make a video talking about how I went 10-0 in the KC Cup with this deck. That would be fantastic. I can't wait to make that video. And I lost to this bullshit, and I was furious. I remember because I felt like it ruined my fucking video, and I wasted all that time playing this guy. And then 604, 613 clapped, and then this guy got clapped. So, yeah. And this duel from here to here, this took 7 minutes. And this Zention guy, I'm pretty sure this was the one where it was like Cyber End Dragon with the chalice and all that other shit. So it's a lot of drama, man. It's a lot of drama. And I also feel like when I'm playing KC Cup and I play against people from other countries, I kind of feel weird about that because I kind of feel like KC Cup is like a regional. And I feel like I should only be playing against people from America. But, you know, whatever. Well, this guy, he's playing the Cyber Dragon tilt. And I summoned my favorite beast, Borky Lion. All right. Put that Borky down. He summoned a wagon. Okay. And then he summoned the Vir. All right. And then he played a core. Okay. Then he gets the fusion. And he's like, I'm going to fuck you up. I'm like, no, you ain't. Then he's like, oh. Support, well, fusion boy. And I was like, fuck. And then he was like, oh, I'm blowing your shit up. And I was like, chain, dog. And got a boost. And he was like, shit. And then he said, well, fuck it then. cyber style. Then he could do nothing. Oh, yes. Oh, then it got even more spicy. Oh, sweet Jesus. Oh. Yeah, this is the move right here. This is the double move. Yeah, this is the double. Oh, yeah. So he summons in a big brain, high IQ, rare duelist move to defend his life points from a monster at 4,400 attack that can negate all the traps, which he did not even play a single one, by the way. He summons Chimera Tech Over Dragon at 4,800, but he does not know I have another battle tuned in my hand. So, you know, I give him that punishment with another battle tune. And you know, what's sad about this tilt right here, this is why Casey Cup, hate fucking Casey Cup, okay? This is why people hate it. We are fighting for nothing. We're barely even fighting for glory because YouTube decides that. And YouTube decides that they're gonna send out, you know, decayed shit, and he gets the most views on most shit. So if he popped up and said fucking ass and titties was fucking the best deck, people just gonna start fucking playing it. Cause they, you know, he's a trusted source. Nothing wrong with that. You know, he can do that and then shape the entire fucking meta. And then that's all you'll be seeing in here. And you'll be getting your clap going because, you know, you're running anti-meta bull. But the crazy thing is, a maniac shows up, anything shows up, and the tilt that this man gave me, the tilt that top KC player gave me, the rage that I felt from that loss because he stole my video. That's what I felt like. I felt like he stole my video from me because I wasn't even thinking about that. I wasn't even thinking about dueling anymore. I thought about my video at that point. The rage I felt here, I delivered to this man directly. You know what I'm saying? He's playing Cyber Dragon. He's not playing fucking tiered meta. It's a cycle, bro. It's a cycle of salt. It just continues to go. It's ultimate. It's insane. So it's like he tilted me and pissed me off. I tilted him and pissed him off. And then this guy, I don't know, I guess he just died. Like, and I said, I'm done. That's 10 games. I'm done. I'm dead. I'm done. I'm out of this. I am finished, bro. Like, and that's what happens, man. It's sad, bro. It's sad. Cause I was so tilted. And so was he. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I know what you're saying, bro. Casey overall isn't worth it at all. It was revenge, my boy. And what I think is funny about, like, the situation that, like, Decade is in or Dueling's Meta is in or whatnot, it's because it's interesting because I remember way back in the day when he topped with that ninja deck and everybody kind of felt like he was, like, obligated to share, like, the best deck with everybody, and they said that he was holding back like a secret deck and they was mad at him because of that. And what was funny about that was, like, and I think I said it back then, I say it again now, is that, like, people felt so entitled basically to his fucking brain and his deck list that I guess they couldn't see past him clapping with ninjas and how amazing that was, that he created a random rogue deck and subverted the entire meta with a ninja deck when nobody was fucking with ninjas. That was cool. That was amazing. You know what I'm saying? But after that, it was like, well, shit, if Decay say that shit is legit, it's fucking legit. And he'll say anything's legit and it will directly affect the KC Cup. It will directly affect the fucking rank duels. And it's funny to just see that influence. Like, that kind of influence is insane. And it's interesting just to see, like, because you don't know who's playing the deck. Like, are people playing it because they really think it's the best deck? Are they playing it because they're just trying it out? Are they playing it just because he said it was the best deck? You know, you don't know. But all you know is, as a random Joe duelist, everybody's playing ass and titties now. And now you're like, well, fuck. Maybe I should play ass and titties too. And then when you hop up in the ladder, and then you look and be like, whoa, everyone seems to be playing ass and titties. I need to play my cheek clapping deck. And then, you know, shit like this is born. And then there you go. But it's insane, though. It's insane. Cause I remember what I forgot what deck it was, but it was some deck. It was some random annoying OTK deck. Not OTK. It was an FTK style deck. And it wasn't the bamboo, but it was something else. And Decay played it like one time, and it was just forever like locked on the meta for like a week. It wasn't even like a meta deck. Like, people just was playing it. It was just insane. So I don't know. It's insane. So Noah influenced me heavily. Wait, he said Noah influences me heavily than your glass cannon deck. What? I don't remember my glass cannon deck. Said watch Decay play Grave Keepers and say it's his secret deck. Oh, Grave Keepers is like a good deck. You know, he should know about Grave Keepers, you know, getting punished by fucking Necro Valley. I mean think about it. Shiranui, not necessarily the Karakuri deck, because that uses oil, but it doesn't use a ton of grave effects. But Shiranui, Invoke, Cyber Dragon, Lunalight, Rogue decks. Damn near everything is affected by Necro Valley. And even though you can out it easily with all types of spell cards and effects, that's the one deck you specifically need a Cosmic Cyclone, because their boss monster prevents destruction to their spell card. So yeah. I remember that. Oh yeah, and the handless deck too. Oh yeah, and that's also another one of those decayed big brain decks he had made. He made that handless deck back in the day with Gaia, the Swift Gaia, the Fierce Knight, and fucking. Damn, there's a level 4 monster. I can't remember. It's Swift Gaia, like Sergeant Electro, and some other guy that was like, if you don't have cards in your hand, do some bullshit. And it was like a handless deck running a bunch of back row. And a handless combo deck was fucking sweet. And I'm not gonna lie, like, honestly, like, somebody like Decade, like, existing his channel and content and how he does it, like there could be no YTDan. Cause, like, you know, how are you gonna be the rogue maniac to always try to fight against the meta, and there's no one kind of pushing or driving a specific idea? And he's pushing and driving specific ideas. And when he pushes and drives specific ideas, and then he has the meta weeklies and stuff like that, it creates a literal, it creates a zeitgeist. It creates like a form, like a something physical to look at and fight against or work towards. And when you come up against something like the KC Cup, you see not just only his work, but you see the work of him and every other duelist who participates to play the best decks. And they've all come together from their victories through YCS, the KC Cup in the past, the fucking King of Games, all that stuff. They come through all that to bring it all together for you in one spot in the KC Cup. And then you, as a rogue duelist, get to subvert the meta with some beautiful random creation and make them all go, huh? And make them all say, nani? But honestly, pulling the rug, man. Pulling the rug. I'm gonna actually try that shit out, man. Pulling the rug. Pulling the rug and bad aim. Woo! I think that's a good combination. There's only one card in the game that says pulling, my boy. One card in Duel Links. And that's the fucking rug. I'm gonna pull the rug, my boy. Shit. Man. I remember Karibo Hazy Flame was insane. Karibo Hazy Flame. That was my first little, my first never miss deck. Karibo Hazy Flame. Love that deck. The first one. That's when I discovered the power, dog. Damn, nostalgic. And it's crazy that we're nostalgic. And I'm about to, let me see. Oh, we just hit the 3 hours, my boy. Well, catch me next time as I regale you with even more stories, my boy. But real talk though, I do enjoy, like you know, it's fun to play against all this crazy stuff and know and understand a meta, but then it's even more fun when you play against the meta as if the meta is an actual enemy that needs to be defeated. And every month, it's a new enemy. I mean, I enjoy it like that. Like, that's literally how I used to play. Like, honestly, think about it like this. When you go to locals, there's always a top player at locals, right? The top player at locals, everyone gets around. He's that guy that they want to net deck him. They're writing his deck list down. They're doing all that shit, right? So you think about it like this. Duel Links, how we're connected through the internet, is just one gigantic fucking locals, okay? It's a gigantic fucking locals, okay? It's loud, it's stanking, you know what I'm saying? You know, it's locals, man. People brought food where they wasn't supposed to bring it. They making trades, they selling shit, you know what I'm saying? It's locals. And Decade is that guy at the top table that everybody likes. But I just so happen to be that guy that shows up to the tournament every single week with a rogue deck to just throw the monkey wrench in everybody's game plan. Cause think about it like this. If you don't got people trying to throw monkey wrenches into your game plan, how can you ever refine your deck to be strong enough to become world champion? You gotta fight randos and top guys. Cause when you get to the top, you might get a random maniac. You know what I'm saying? You play against a random maniac, and you're like, no, I've never fought a maniac before. What do I do against Jimmy Samuel and his 30 card deck? Nothing, you lose. Cause he's gonna play Fissure and summon Hayabusa Knight and equip him with Power of the Guardian and Acts of Despair, and you're gonna lose. And you're gonna be looking like all my training, all of my prowess, all the time I spent no lifing for the invitation to lose to Hayabusa Knight and Power of the Guardian. You'd be disgusted, my boy. You'd be disgusted. But honestly though, it's always like that. I think that's what makes Yu-Gi-Oh fun. That rivalry. Like the, I know I'm gonna stop these invokers today. Today the invokers will not win. Like showing up to stop the invokers. Like, I'm here to kill all invokers. They like, but Dan, I am an invoker. And you look at him like, you gonna die. You know what I'm saying? It is. Hey, it is what it is, my boy. But I'm about to get out of here, my boy. Thanks for watching. One day, and I'll tell you like this. I'm gonna tell you, this is some real talk, my boy. This is a YTDan guarantee. One day the sun is gonna shine on your boy. Opportunity is gonna open up. And I'm gonna get a shot at a YCS, no life or something. I'm gonna get a shot, my boy. And when I get the shot and I get the top and I play and I win, when they hand me the mic and they say, hey, you got something to say? I never miss. I'm gonna say it and you'll remember it. 434 people are gonna remember it. That's that I told you I'm gonna say it. And I live for that day. I'm gonna do it one day. Shane Dan, thanks for becoming a member, my boy. I appreciate it, my boy. Coming through supporting your boy at the end of the thing. Boy, damn. But that's what I'm saying, man. That's, one day I'm gonna do it. One day. And I'm a patient man. It don't have to be today. It don't gotta be tomorrow. I never wanted that ever in my life until I became a YouTuber, until I became someone who duels for more than just myself, dueling for the entertainment of other people. I have never wanted quote unquote mainstream glory. I was satisfied with throwing the monkey wrench in the game and just being known as that guy who makes good decks. I was satisfied, more than satisfied. But when I got introduced to this YouTube shit and Duel Links and the world, like everything, that changed my perspective on dueling. And that made me desire to compete at the higher levels. And I want, not, I never wanted to become champion. I still don't want to become a champion per se, but I wouldn't mind if I became a champion while completing my other goal, which is competing at the highest level, winning, just so I can get a chance to say it, I never miss. And then I can go ahead and just stamp me in. Bam, I'm the best anime protagonist ever. First black Yu-Gi-Oh protagonist in history. Go ahead and put me up right next to fucking Obama and fucking Condoleezza Rice and fucking whoever else is black who did some shit first. Put me right there. put me right there. Right there. Hey, like, who's that? That's Martin Luther King. Who's that? That's Malcolm X. Who's that? That's YT Dan. What did he do?
He's a true duelist.
That's what I'm saying, my boy. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, my boy. I'm going to do it. One day I'm going to do it. One day. And honestly, oh, and I'll tell you this before I leave. I'll tell you this before I leave. When I went to that Yu-Gi-Oh event in California right before COVID, I was gonna play in the tournament and I wanted to play in that tournament so fucking bad. I wanted to play so bad, but they had Yummy Bakura in a spot and it was an odd number of people and I got knocked off. So I didn't get to play. And Yummy Bakura was late. So they was like, well, fuck it. We're gonna let Dan play in Yummy's spot. And I was and on the inside. Now I'm gonna tell you some real talk. I'm gonna tell you some real talk. On the inside, I was burning up, flaming passion, ready to duel. When they said, "Hey Dan, you think you can just jump in?" My real answer was like,
"I was born ready to duel."
But. When they asked, I was like, oh, cool, yeah. Then Yummy Bakura showed up. And when she showed up, because what happened was everything was already set up and it had her name on the shit. So, because her name was already on the shit, it was easier to keep her in her spot because she showed up late than to change everything and put me on because they had already started. So when they told me I wasn't gonna play and Yummy was gonna play, I'm not gonna lie, it hit me in my guts and I'm like, ooh. But outside Dan was like, oh yeah, it's cool. I appreciate you bringing me, let me come and shit, blah, blah, blah. Because it was a fluke that I got knocked off. It was a fluke that I got joined back on. And then it was bad luck, I guess, or inconvenience for me that I end up not being able to play. And then she end up winning the whole thing. And when she ended up winning the whole thing and I knew I was gonna be sitting in her seat playing on her pad, I was like, well, shit, I could have won the whole thing. It could have been me. But it wasn't like I wasn't mad at her. I literally was looking like, damn, I would have made that play. Damn, I would have attacked for game. Damn. Damn. Like, I literally was looking like shit. I'm like, she's clapping. I was like, I would have been clapping just as well. Oh, Lord Jesus. It was just so funny because it was like, and it was only funny. Excuse me. It was funny, like, not funny, ha ha, but funny, like, if this was a movie and somebody was watching it, they'll be like, damn, I see the oof. Like, I see, like, why he feel the way he feel. But I also see why he didn't say nothing, because honestly, the only reason I had even came to the event is because I found an email from a third party group that invited me on behalf of Konami that went to my spam. So how I ended up last on the list to duel in the first place is because I found the invitation by chance. Because they've been sending me shit for months and it was always going to spam and I never knew. So I felt in a way just lucky to be there, because I wouldn't even had have gotten it in the first place if I never checked my spam randomly that one time. Like, so in my mind, I'm thinking, you know, is it like, this is what I was thinking in my mind. I was thinking, was it like, was my fate sealed when I, you know, used a different email? Was my fate sealed when I looked in there and found it? Like, at what point could I have turned the key? And I would have got the opportunity to get in there. And I don't think there really was one, because I didn't know that it was a thing until the last minute. And when I reached out, they were like, oh, we still got space, you can come. And it was cool. And I brought my boy that was helping me edit videos too. So that was also a thing too. So that was just, it was a nice experience and I really enjoyed it. And they had that tournament and I was so hyped to participate. But it was not in my fate to do so. But I did get to do some commentary and I found that I had some fun doing that. And I think I said I never missed or something like that in the commentary or some shit. I said something ridiculous in the commentary. That one chick was like a professional commentator girl. That was just, it was a lot. So, but honestly, I want that chance, because the only reason I want the, like, that mainstream chance, like I told you, like I got to start talking to all these people and it just, like, talking to all of y'all, and it just got me like, okay, this is something that not only, because it's not, I'm going to buffer what I'm going to say. I do not mean any type of offense to anyone or anything, but I remember there was a conversation, not a conversation, there was a discussion about Yu-Gi-Tubers that commentated on Yu-Gi-Oh, like the TCG, but they didn't have any credibility when it came to tournament wins and placements and stuff like that, right? And sure, I guess that's a valid argument, but does one need to be, you know, a master carpenter to put a chair together? Like, I don't think so. Or even to tell you to put a chair together, I don't think so. But that was a big conversation. And people like Sam, for example, from Team Samurai, like, he's competitive and he, you know, he was getting the fuck in there. And I remember watching that, like, after the aftermath, it was almost like he got fired up. And he started going out and he was like placing in regionals and topping at like other big events and getting YCS invites. And, you know, like, you know, Sam was like killing it. Like, he was like, was whooping ass. And then he was doing it like, I want to say kind of rogue style, but he was doing it with his own stuff. I think he was doing it right before like Masterpiece and stuff got like big. And then he started playing like Masterpiece, start clapping with Masterpiece and all that shit. And then time went on and Masterpiece got banned and blah, 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 blah. But the whole thing was, from my point of view, as a viewer, as a fan outside looking in, I saw that the Ether decided to quote unquote call out the Yu-Gi-Tubers and say, hey, you guys ain't shit because you guys don't actually place in tournaments. You just talk about Yu-Gi-Oh. Fuck you guys, basically. They basically was like, there are no decades among you, is what they were saying, right? You know, and when they said that, Sam was like, I'm stepping the fuck up. And I watched it, and it was amazing to watch. So I was like, I want to do the same thing. But unfortunately, I got a little life coming in. But one day, because I thought 2020 was going to be my year for that. Like, I'm not going to lie. 2020, I thought was going to be the year I was going to do all that kind of stuff. But shit, I had a baby. I mean, we was hoping and planning for it, but you know, you still got to live your life, you know. You know, anything can happen, unfortunately. So yeah, it's crazy. So it's like, I don't know, it's pretty nuts. No, I am not the Farfa of Duel Links. No, because Farfa got banned. Farfa got banned. I'm not the Farfa of Duel Links. I can still duel. But yeah, my boy. Well, I don't know if he's still banned, but I remember he got banned a long time ago for some shit. I don't remember what though. But yeah, it's interesting because what I think, this is what I really think. Oh yeah, and a baby definitely is better for sure. But you know, what I really think is interesting is how the Yu-Gi-Oh anime became real and nobody fucking noticed it. Like, we don't have dual schools per se, but if you want to, you can get tutelage from like Duel Links Meta website and other places too. You know, we have all these tournaments and all these world events and people get flown out and do shit. We got dueling celebrities, you know, all that shit. You know, we got all that shit. You got rogue duelists, serious duelists, you know, business duelists, surprise people you wouldn't think play Yu-Gi-Oh! That actually duel and willing to duel you. And then you got Duel Links that connects us all. And you can pick that up anytime, anywhere. And you don't even need cards. That's a powerful thing, man. Anime became real just like that. The only thing we don't got is fucking shadow magic. But I mean, goddamn, the real world's so fucking scary. I wish we had some fucking shadow magic. The real world's so dangerous. Fucking shadow magic is nothing. Yeah, I'm gonna send you to the shadow realm. How about fucking dead? Like, what? Like, it's just crazy. So it's like, you know, that's what I'm saying. Like, so if you, it depends on like, you know, how deep do you want to go down the Yu-Gi-Oh rabbit hole, my boy? Do you want to be a casual fan that duels from time to time? Do you want to be a madman and create content for Yu-Gi-Oh for free until the community says it's good? Do you want to duel and become a world champion? You know what I'm saying? You got the options as a duelist because it's not just about the cards anymore. It's not just about the game. It's about the game, the lifestyle, and everything. And I've been watching Yu-Gi-Oh! Zexal, the English dub, and they are literally dropping these lessons on you as you watch this anime. The guy said, I'm going to quit playing Yu-Gi-Oh! They thought Shark quit. They said, what happened to Shark? They said, I heard Shark quit. He gave up dueling. And then what's his name? The fucking, you know, old boy, the main character from fucking Zexal. He said, that's really sad. He said, you're supposed to duel for life. He's like, you should never give up dueling. It's always so sad when a duelist gives up the game. He said that shit like this motherfucker was dead. He said it like he was 6 feet under. And they was over here trying to figure out if he still had life insurance. He said that shit like he was gone. You know what I'm saying? He said that shit like he was dead. Like, not fucking dead in the game. Not fucking moved away. Not, I don't talk with him. I don't fuck with him no more. He said it like he was dead. Like, oh my God. He seems so distraught. So hurt. You can hear it in his voice. And I mean, it's true. Cause my best friend doesn't play Yu-Gi-Oh and I can't even get him to play Duel Links. I bought him a damn gift card to play fucking Duel Links. And he was like, fuck that. I'm playing Clash of Clans just to fuck me up. Says Shadow Realm is just like Ohio. Damn. Damn it, dog. But yeah, pretty much. Or like, it's like, now you're going to Brazil. Oh, not Brazil. But I'm saying, like straight up, man, it's crazy. So like Yu-Gi-Oh became real out of nowhere. And then every now and again, they hit you with the truth, my boy. They hit you with the reality. 5 billion duels. 5 billion duels. That makes you have to reflect and say, how many duels have I had? And me by myself, 56,000 duels just on this app. Not in my life. On this app, 56,000 duels. How many duels did I have in real life? I never counted. But I know it had to be more than 56,000. So can you imagine doing anything 56,000 times? Can you imagine? You wouldn't even think about that. If I sat you down in a chair and told you, you got to duel 56,000 duels, motherfucker, and like it, you would probably just be like, no! Like, you probably lose your mind. You lose your fucking shit. You know what I'm saying? But when you look at this in context, 5 billion duels since 2016 or 2020. Think about it. Trump became the president. We got Duel Links. Trump on the way out. We dueled 5 billion times. Now, and that's just in America. You know, other shit was going on other places. Brexit and all that other crazy shit. But I'm just saying, think about that. Think about how insane it is. One presidential term, there was 5 billion duels in 4 years. Billion. 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 As Trump would say, billion. Billion, like bill and yen, billion. 5 billion duels. That's crazy. That's just a lot of duels. Says I quit Duel Links being forced to duel that much. Hey man, 56,000 duels. And I remember one time I was playing and I got on live stream and it said live duels and it was no event going on. It was no events. It was nothing going on. This shit was like legend back in the day. It said 500 duels. They're like, how does this man have 500 fucking duels and not king of games? I'm like, I'm literally getting in there every waking moment of the fucking day, playing every fucking deck. Cause honestly, I'll tell you straight up, when Duel Links first came out, man, I just played this game religiously all the time. Every waking moment before I even had YouTube. It was always on. I was always playing it. I was in the bathroom playing it, in the bed playing it, just playing. Not because I was playing some uber competitive deck or anything like that. I just loved that it was on my phone. I loved the music. I loved the animations. I thought it was so amazing. I just thought it was the most amazing thing ever. And it was all on my fucking phone. And I just thought it was so great. And I just kept playing. And if you go back and watch that first video I ever made on Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links, that one about the Thunder Dragon engine way back in the day, you look at the excitement on my face, how happy I was just to even talk about it. Like, I really do feel like when it comes to like Yu-Gi-Oh!, There's like a subset of people that play the game. You got your, you know, your people who play the game, who enjoy the game very casually, and they kind of keep Yu-Gi-Oh in its little space, and they do Yu-Gi-Oh, but you know, everything else is separate and these never cross, okay? And then you got other people where the card game is their life, and it becomes a part of their everyday being. Like, they're people that they know, you know, all the friends, you know, all their connections are all through the game. And that was me. Like, that was me. Like, Yu-Gi-Oh was my life. Like, all my friends played Yu-Gi-Oh, you know, and it was just like the anime. I can't even lie to you. I had a Yu-Gi-Oh anime experience. All my friends played Yu-Gi-Oh. All my family knew about it. It was the most important thing to me than anything. I dueled at work. Like some random dude came and challenged me to a duel. I used to work at Taco Bell, okay? This random guy came to the Taco Bell and challenged me to a duel. And my manager allowed it to happen and said, if you can beat him, I'ma get you a free meal. But he said, but if you lose, Dan, you gotta pay for it. I was like, what the fuck? So I dueled so that I wouldn't lose $7. He got his cheeks clapped. He summoned the Mad Dog of Darkness, and I knew I was going to win this game. He summoned the Mad Dog of Darkness in past turn. I was playing some kind of combo deck. Whatever I was playing, I'm sure it blew his mind. But he was like, I summoned the Mad Dog of Darkness. I was like, guess you won't be getting a Taco Supreme. Yes, for real, bro. At my Taco Bell. Like, it was just bullshit. Like I dueled this man for a Taco fucking Supreme. Crazy. Then after that bullshit, you know, I'm just having random Yu-Gi-Oh experiences. I come across this guy that I play Yu-Gi-Oh with casually. We become cool. From this dude I meet my wife through him and got married and have a son now. And it never would have happened if I never dueled. And that's the craziest shit I lay in the bed and think about all the time. If I chose to quit playing Yu-Gi-Oh at any point before I met that guy, I would have never met the person I married. We would have never had the son I have now. It, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's the kind of stuff I think about sometimes, like how crazy that is and how it's just tied to this game. To some people, it's nothing, but to me, it's everything because it connects so much that I care about. And it's strange that it connects so many things. So, you know, I think about that sometimes, like, you know, And then from that standpoint, think about it like this. If I never had this deep passion and connection for Yu-Gi-Oh and cared about it so much, I never would have uploaded that first video to talk about Thunder Dragon Bandit Key Switcheroo because I would have thought it was so busted. I never would have did it. If I never would have did it, I wouldn't be streaming. And I didn't even know I liked this. I didn't even know that I liked this. I didn't know that this was something for me, but I found something through Yu-Gi-Oh yet again. So that's just the kind of shit that be keeping me like up at night sometimes. It's like, would my fate had it been sealed if I chose Pokemon? What if I kept playing the Yu Yu Hakusho trading card game competitively? What if I stuck with the Naruto trading card game like some of my friends did? What if I quit like my best friend? What would have happened? You don't know. Oh man, I'm not gonna cry. I have cried so many times for happiness about these things. So it's like, yeah, I definitely not. But yeah, and you ask, does she duel? Yeah, she actually knows how to play. And I was the only person to actually teach her how to play because, you know, the guy that basically got us introduced, he was trying to teach her how to play, but he was a bad player. And I don't want to call him a bad player, like bad player, but he didn't really know the rules all that well. And then someone who doesn't know the rules all that well, trying to explain them to someone else. And then back in the day, he had to explain erratas, spell speed, priority, all that kind of shit. So he's explaining the rules that are beyond the rules to someone who doesn't even understand what the fuck you're talking about in the first place. So, you know, when we got together, she didn't start playing initially, but she started playing later on. And we played Pokemon, we played Magic, we played Cardfight Vanguard, we played Yu-Gi-Oh, Speed Duels. And, you know, and she's into it at, you know, at a point, but she's not into it like me. Like she, like you wouldn't catch my wife at a Yu-Gi-Oh tournament, dueling it up. But one time, actually, we did go to a Pokemon tournament, my wife, my friend and myself and his girlfriend, and we all went to this Pokemon tournament and we all competed. That was a very funny weekend. My wife was, it was so funny. She was playing Blastoise Water Deck, and she didn't have a Turtle Beach stadium card. And the Turtle Beach stadium card, just imagine, a very expensive card. It was like $120 and you needed like four of them. So she played a mirror match against some guy and he played Turtle Beach. He was one of those stereotypical, really big, really fat, kind of stinky neck beard dudes, looking disheveled, looking like shit, but he's got four fucking Turtle Beaches in his deck. He's got $480 worth of Turtle Beach in his deck. He played Turtle Beach. My wife replaced Turtle Beach with some random stadium card. And I said, what do you say when you did that? And she said, just like anime, it was so funny. She said, I remembered you told me by using this other card, I could subvert my opponent's play even if they relied on the Turtle Beach. I was like, oh, Lord. Lordy. And she won that game. She won that game. So it was good, man. It was good, man. It was good. Oh man, my wife does not want to be on the video, and she's lit, and not for any particular reason, but she's like camera shy, so she just does not want to do the thing. But that was, you know, but that shit was real, bro. And that was the first time she ever went to a tournament, and she played. She didn't win or nothing or place or anything, and I didn't win or place or anything. We were just kind of casually having fun, but it was an experience just to take somebody to another, you know, thing that, and this was not her world. This was not what she was into. She's literally there for me, you know? So I appreciated that. You know what I'm saying? So it was cool. It was cool. But when the Yu-Gi-Oh stuff come back around, like, you know, I'm ready. You know, I'm ready. Soon as my son is like, mommy, daddy, I'm like, oh, so you know mommy and daddy. So what you telling me is you ready to learn this alphabet so that you can learn how to read. And then you telling me also, because you now you know how to read, you ready to, you know, learn mathematics. And, you know, I'm gonna teach you how to count and shit. Oh, wow, you know how to read and do math? Let me introduce you to a little game called Yu-Gi-Oh. Baby can't walk, talk, or poop on his own, but he can read and do math. And father used his extreme intelligence at a young age to play a card game that was designed for him, by the way. Just saying. Use a card game that was designed for him, okay? And that's what we're gonna do. And then they're gonna say, gonna be in class. The teacher's gonna say, Dan, I'm gonna need you to do this. And he's gonna say, I'm not gonna do it, teacher. And he said, in fact, I challenge you to a duel. And if you lose, you'll have to clean it yourself. I'm like, did you really say that to her? You're like, yes. I'm gonna say, my son. Oh, God. I mean, you should not say that to the teacher. Oh. Or it would be hilarious if he said it ever. If like some shit goes down and he's like, Dad, I'm gonna need an additional $5 of my allowance. I'm like, I can't do it. The budget is not supporting that right now. Well, father, I challenge you to a duel. And if you lose, you must raise my allowance. But if you win, I will never speak of the raise again.
And I'll be like,
let's do.
No way you're getting out of here with raised allowance, boy.
Duel this activating hollow images.
You'll never leave with the raised allowance.
Impossible. How'd you get those expensive cards? Foolish daddy. While you were out making videos, I was commencing with the trades, and I've traded for this entire 40-card deck. No, my son. It's too powerful. Don't do it. $5 raise isn't enough. And then it was like, to be continued. House is all torn up, all kinds of fire and flames, everything going crazy. Wife, what's happening in here? I'm like, I'm dueling to save $5 a week. And then it's going to be like, life point penalty. No, mother, you can't do this. I'm sorry, son. But to prevent the budget from increasing, you must be defeated. And I would look over like, wife, eyes big and glittery. Oh, you willing to duel on my behalf to save our budget? Damn, I can't afford to lose this duel. Son summons Exodia somehow. I'm gonna say, though I respect you for summoning such a powerful monster, my son, I'm disgusted that you summoned Exodia from your 60 card deck that has Power of the Guardian in it. Yeah, as you can see, I've been thinking about these ridiculous Yu-Gi-Oh-esque scenarios. I challenge you to a duel, and if you lose, you must mow the lawn forever. If you lose, you'll do the dishes forever. I'm always going to end it with forever. Oh my God. He's going to be married. He's going to be married. He's going to be 39 years old. And his wife's going to say, why do you always go back to your dad's house to do the dishes every night? You wouldn't understand. And then one day I'm going to be sleeping, and then the door's going to get kicked in. And it's this woman here going like, all right, I'm challenging you to a duel. And if you lose, you must free my husband from his obligation to do your dishes. I'll be like, impossible. I was like, but I have no incentive to duel you. She's like, fool, I've already sent your wife and dog to the shadows. I'm like, what? All this would happen. He's 39 years old. I don't know why. All this happened. I'll be an old man like, you are barking up the wrong tree. Life points are here. Fucking Exodia. Like some shit. I don't know. I think when I actually become an old man, like a really, really, really old man, and my shit is gray as fuck, I think I'm just gonna play Exodia exclusively. This is all I'm gonna play. Because I would have lived an entire life of Yu-Gi-Oh! For the existence of the entire show. And if Exodia is still a thing, it's almost like the obligation of any old man to play that ancient deck. You know what I'm saying? The first OTK. You know what I'm saying? Exodia. The first episode, Exodia. Like, it's gonna be nuts. And then on top of that, you got a legendary deck that nobody knows about, and you pass it along to some random duelist like, here you go, sonny. You remind me of someone I used to know. You know, and he just changed their life and created a destiny. See what I'm saying? Now that guy's gonna save the fucking world. You know what I'm saying? Shit. When I think about it, that would mean if I became a grandpa, that would mean my son's son would be Yugi. That would be crazy. My son's son would be Yugi. Not my son. My son's son would be Yugi. And I'd be all like, Yugi. He's like, granddad, my name isn't Yugi. I'm like, Yugi. He's like, dad, why does he keep calling me that? It's like, he's starting to get senile, son. Yugi. He's losing his mind. He thinks he's locked in a ceremonial duel. But he's been doing the same thing for 20 years. He says, my boy said another classic growing up with YTDan. Said, what if one day your child hits you with drowning metaphors? Wait, hits me with drowning. Well, I hope one day my child does not hit me with drowning. I die. but if you meant drowning metaphors, well, okay. Well, that would be that would be broke. That would be busted. But I'm sure he can just use regular metaphors or anything else in his repertoire. So, you know, that would all be spicy. But I gotta get out of here. I'm talking all this shit. It's nearly 4 hours. And I gotta go. But I had fun, as always. This is what I'm talking about. I would not be in such a jovial tone and mood at the end of a KC Cup duels. Like, literally, last night, after I finished this KC Cup, after I did my KC Cup duels last night, I literally laid down in the bed and said, because I was satisfied that I had those 10 games and, you know, and it was like over, and I knew that I wasn't going to play it at all. And I just was like, but I'm still salty about this bitch, but I'm about to go. Actually, you know, it's messed up. If somebody did become old and they got dementia, but they thought they were in a perpetual duel for the rest of their life until they died, would that be hell or heaven? I guess it just depends on the duelist. I'm gonna let that knock around in your head meet for the night. Good night, sweet dreams, and don't let the MST bite, my boy. Keep it dank. Yes. Thanks for coming through, my boys. Loving the content and chilling for my random speech about all kinds of shit that I like to talk about. You know, it's Yu-Gi-Oh, my boy. That's what we like to do. Actually, I've been bumping around with this idea. I've been thinking about doing this, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to do it. I'm just going to figure out some logistics, but don't hold me to it. But I'm thinking about doing this, something like a watch party kind of thing. For like the Yu-Gi-Oh anime, kind of like a watch along, but I'm gonna use Twitch to do it because I do want to start. Hey, Pencil, thanks for the sub, my boy. I'm gonna use Twitch to do it because I want to start using my Twitch more, and that's gonna be different than the Duel Links content. So, and also it's gonna be kind of risky, but I'm gonna kind of like set it up so that I don't get screwed in terms of copyright, but I also want to set it up so that, you know, people can join the stream whenever and understand where I am and just be able to jump in by using the links. I plan on using, like, you know, official Yu-Gi-Oh, the official Yu-Gi-Oh YouTube page to do this. So I think that's going to be pretty fun, and it's going to be like, I've watched some other people doing it, and I'm not just going to be sitting there not saying anything and eating some chips and going, oh, bland commentary. I'm be talking shit the whole fucking time about everything they do and everything they say. I'm be talking about they misplays and all that bullshit. But I want to do that, and I'll probably do that on Twitch. So, again, I'm just getting the logistics together. This is my first month actually being back on point. This is the first time I've went 20 days, you know, 4 weeks, basically, Well, I'm talking about business, but that's maybe Friday. And it's not even 4 weeks, but basically 3 weeks. This is the first time I've went like 3 weeks consistently in a really long time. Really, really, really long time. So I want to get through this month and stay consistent. And then move into the next month, I'm going to add a little something more. And then move into the next month, I'm going to add a little something more. I'm going to just keep edging a little more content here and there until I have like a full palette of content. So that's just what the plan is. And I'm just dropping that on y'all. But yeah, that's it, my boys. All right, I'm getting out of here. Good night. Thanks for watching the stream. And I appreciate everybody for listening to my chat. Keep it.